Because we're ish.
Don't cry, just get used to it, kid. You're gonna keep getting owned by this evangelist. All atheists are sitting, watching, feeling all alone. We Christians have to work through Satan. That atheist owned.
God is doing a new thing in our lives. We're doing a new thing through Jesus Christ. God is doing a new thing through our music. We're doing a new thing so he can use it. Oh, yeah. It's me. You know he's doing it. Who's doing it? God is doing a new thing. You know he's doing it. Yo, who's doing it? God is doing a new thing. You know he's doing it. God is doing a new thing. You know he's doing it. Do it. God is doing a new thing. Like an MC, I'm here to boast. I rap about Christ, yo, he is a dope. So loud and proud of the guy I serve. Try to thank you with a hope. You got nerve. Christ is a reason for my gold glances. He's a focus of a daily walk, y'all. Without him, he ain't not my name. But through God, we're doing brand new things. God is doing a new thing in our lives. So we're doing a new thing through Jesus Christ. God is doing a new thing.
You are about to experience the Drunken Peasants Podcast, the greatest podcast in human history. Please recognize that this podcast is designed to be amusing and entertaining, and thus we engage in satirical comments, exaggerations, and even dirty jokes. If you are offended by such things, please go away and die. If you enjoy this podcast, we ask that you help to support its existence by contributing to our Patreon at patreon.com/DP. Contributors get regular access to monthly private shows, special commentaries, Google Hangouts with the peasants, and more. If you don't want to do that, you can also support the show by visiting audibletrial.com/drunkenpeasants to get a free audiobook and access to over 150,000 audiobook titles, including great selections on science and skepticism. And if you shop on Amazon.com, we strongly urge you to use one of the Amazon affiliate links in the description section of our videos. You can help support the show simply by using our link to buy things you are going to buy anyway. Now that we've got all that shit out of the way, sit back and enjoy the show.
Live from the frigid armpit of America, this is the Drunken Peasants Podcast with Ben and TJ, bringing you opinions of the news from an altered perspective.
Fuck it!
Hey man, you got a joint? No, on you, man.
I don't have facts to back this up.
It'd be a lot cooler if you did.
What the fuck are you talking about, atheist?
It's okay.
You're nothing, okay. KJ. You're garbage.
I just want to be light.
You're garbage.
And now, here Ben, and TJ.
We'll do it live. We'll do it live! Fuck it! Do it live! Fucking thing sucks!
Han Solo is dead! Welcome to the Drunken Peasants Podcast!
Number 188! I never thought we'd make it. I knew for sure we'd make it to 187, but 188.
Yeah, man, when you first told me about this podcast idea, I was like, yeah, it'll probably make it 187 episodes.
Yeah.
Ain't no way it's going 188, though. But I was wrong.
So, TJ,
here we are.
What is your favorite episode?
What's my favorite episode? 188, bitch.
So every new episode is your favorite episode?
No, not every episode.
Just this one.
From the beginning, even though I only thought it was going to go 187 episodes, I always said if it did get to 188, that's going to be the best. And it had a great start, you know?
No, actually, it's going to be episode...
Everything being fucked up and shit,
219.
You know what I blame, though?
219.
You know who's here tonight? Fucking Scotty Cena. He's fucking around here somewhere.
Yeah, he didn't think...
He didn't think Scotty was coming, so he was here.
Yep.
I think he ran out.
Yeah, he ran away.
Scotty here, but I'm pretty sure he fucking had something to do with this, the show being fucked up in the beginning there, man. I think it was Scotty Cena trying to fuck our shit up because he doesn't want Scotty to have a voice. Trying to silence him,
trying
Scotty.
To silence the people, man.
I need Scotty's camera tilted.
Camera is fucking jacked
it needs, to be tilted
dude.
Up.
Tilt that shit up. What are you doing, Scotty?
But seriously, we have.
Sorry,
to...
I've been drinking.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, Scotty, you're retarded. Tilt it more down now. Tilt it more down slightly. Half as much as you just tilted it up. Tilt it down.
Okay, I'll get
that's
the rest.
That's good enough. You got it, Scott.
I've been drinking, TJ. What can I say?
You haven't been drinking.
I've been fucking drinking.
You're drinking a fucking iced tea. That's what you're fucking drinking.
Not iced tea, TJ.
Yeah, it is.
People ask. Someone did like a calculation and calculated that like about 85% of Scotty's sentences end with TJ at the end of them.
Cool.
Cool, TJ, is what you mean.
Yeah.
Cool cat, TJ.
Yeah, there you go.
Cool cat.
How are you guys doing, TJ? What's going on?
I'm cool cat.
TJ.
I'm doing well, Scotty. Thank you for asking, Scotty.
Assing?
Thank you for asking.
Thinking Scotty. Of my ass, aren't you, TJ?
Here, where?
TJ? Okay. TJ? My whole sentence will just be TJ from now on. It'll just be TJ. TJ.
That's for him, it's just punctuation at this point.
I'm really... Well, people just... They don't understand why I'm on the show. I'm on the show just to argue with TJ and just annoy him. That's really about it.
That seems accurate.
Yeah. So, I mean...
That's not only why you're on the show. That's why you're in my life.
Someone made a video specifically about how much Scotty sucks. This vegan guy that we've had on the show before, he made a video about Scotty.
Play it.
How much he hates me.
I'll play it. I'll play it eventually.
Eventually.
We'll get to it.
Why not now?
Because I have...
Because you know what? I know for a fact that Scotty has seen that video.
Really?
And was pissed.
Really?
No, I wasn't.
He was pissed.
You're thinking of something else.
Thinking of something else?
Yeah, you're thinking of something else.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
No.
No, you actually are thinking of something else.
No, I don't think so.
Yeah.
Okay.
Maybe I am.
All right. Here we go. Yeah. Troll or not a troll?
Suck that snot deeper into my nose.
Actually, maybe I should get JF on for the troll or not a troll.
He never cares. He always like, there is a gradient between troll and not a troll and all this shit. Fuck him. JF, what a scumbag. Hey, JF, how you doing, buddy?
Hello, drunken peasants.
Hey, JF, don't do your stupid, there's a gradient of troll and shit. Just fucking go black and white. No.
But share a video with me because I'm not seeing it right now.
Yeah, we'll do it. We're going
to
share...
I have to share shit with you. Give you my fucking HPV. How about that, bitch?
Holy
get some
fucking
genital
shit.
Warts going on.
Holy
That's
shit.
What I'll share.
We're going to share it like this right now, JF. Can you see it?
Wonderful. Yep.
All right, great.
Yeah. Can you see it, JF?
I see it.
All right.
You see nothing.
Here we go.
All it is right now is a black screen. That's all
you see. Are you feeling it now, Donald Trump? Donald Trump, you know you want this ass. Are you feeling it now, Donald Trump?
Are you feeling it now, Donald Trump?
I'm a narwhal for Donald Trump.
Donald Trump is feeling this.
Look, Donald, I'm a narwhal. I'm such a narwhal for you, Donald. You know you
narwhal?
Want this.
Troll. Shouldn't it be on your head?
Troll.
It should be on his head, shouldn't it?
I mean, this is obviously a troll.
No,
that's
I
the whole video.
Say it's obvious.
Yeah.
That's it's not obvious video. To JF, man. It's not obvious to JF. JF's like, show me more of this young boy in lingerie.
Yes, exactly.
Immediately.
Are you feeling it now, Donald Trump? Donald Trump, you know you want it. I'm not Mexican, so you won't have to deport me so we can be teammates.
I say. Not a troll.
Not a troll. You think he really wants to hook up with Donald Trump?
No. I don't think he really wants to hook up with Donald Trump. I just think that this is, like, legitimately in his mind some form of criticism against Donald Trump.
I think the better question is, does JF want to hook up with Donald Trump? You made some comments earlier. You don't.
I think this video actually makes me like Donald Trump less, but...
oh, wow.
Yeah, I'm with TJ. I'm with TJ. This person likes to display sexual behavior. I think he's using Donald Trump here as an excuse, but he wanted to
this
be with
this is my
that,
social
thing.
Commentary, guys. Everyone look at my social commentary video. Why are you dressed like a girl and
why do you have a plunger
like that and putting a plunger on your stomach?
Yeah.
It's my commentary. You just don't get it. You're not sophisticated enough to understand my vision.
You know, TJ, maybe we really aren't.
Then again, he does say narwhal several times, which does make me believe maybe it is a troll. Because, you know, anyone who knows about narwhals actually probably would not.
Dude, it's a troll.
It's a troll, Scotty.
It's a fucking troll. Ben, what do you think?
Troll.
I'm going to stick with not a...
You lose, TJ. You lose.
Wait,
oh,
okay, it's a tie. Whoa. It's a tie.
It's
what the hell?
Yeah, tie.
Nah, you guys lose.
Oh, bullshit.
All right.
My feet itch now.
It hardly ever happens.
No one likes a tie.
I know, but when it does, it's really bad.
What?
All right. Let's see. Let's talk about... The gym at, I mean, seriously, who the fuck would have ever imagined?
Dinor.
Apparently.
I always believed in
gym. The problem with our previous shirts is we were too focused on, like, making them good quality shirts. Apparently, what you really need to do is just put out a total piece of shit
what
shirt.
The this
so
what?
People can be like, yeah, I ironically
Jim
have
ass.
This shirt like this.
Jim Ass is a visionary, and if you guys didn't see it, you're just fucking stupid.
Jim Ass is...
From day one, I always supported Jim Ass.
He's an artist. He's
he
a
is.
Fucking artist, all
right? Buy this fucking shirt right fucking now, and if you don't, then die of AIDS.
Jim Ass is the spiritual successor to Picasso. It's true.
I don't know about that. I think he's the spiritual successor to the Dalai Lama. He's going to be the next Dalai Lama.
The Dalai Lama, huh?
Yes.
I'm sure JF feels the same way.
Yeah, I really like Jim Ass. I think he has some hate inside of him, some anger that he has difficulties releasing. But I'd like
releasing.
To talk to him, so next time he's on the show, I would like to analyze him.
You'd like to
wow.
You'd like to give him a release?
Yes, I'd like to.
Oh, well, that's wonderful.
I'd like to work his mind and see who's inside there.
Yeah, I'm sure you would.
All right, JF, we're going to move right into it.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Would help if I move this out of the way.
God damn.
All right.
Every time, man.
JF, I think we have a challenger against you for your next rap battle.
Oh.
Is it Bob?
No. Even better.
Okay. Another one. Let's
see. Here we go.
Oh, God. I've seen this.
The hood mentality is a crippling disease that attacks your nervous system. It makes you nervous of the system.
Wow.
Gangsters and hood rats are especially susceptible to this growth-stunting mentality. The hood is where I'm from.
Wow.
But it's not what I am.
I want to Every SJW on Earth, every SJW on Earth should be sent this video, because outside of knowing the context of who Gail is, like, yeah. I don't know whether it's better to know about who she is and see this, or not know about who she is.
This is an artistic performance.
I love it.
You have to appreciate it.
She's cutting up a bunch of credit cards.
Not gonna be enslaved by Academy anymore. Bye.
She saw the fucking Vigilant Christian video about credit card debt being evil.
This is where it picks up. This is where it picks up.
How the fuck are we supposed to change our reality if you don't want to shake that hood mentality? How the fuck are we supposed to change our reality if you don't want to shake that hood mentality? How the fuck are we supposed to change our reality if you don't want to shake that hood mentality? How the fuck are we supposed to change our reality?
It says in the description to this video that she got permission from Terrance Jenkins to use the word nigga.
Yeah. He is black.
Okay, so she's really made up as a black person. It's not like smoke or something. She's not acting like there was an explosion. She's trying to simulate blackness?
Yes.
I believe so.
Oh.
Yeah.
This is Gail's blackface video. So
this is Gail's minstrel show. Welcome. I feel like we should have charged people like a halfpenny to view this.
She did mention in the comment section of that video the drunken peasants. Because someone said the drunken peasants are going to be laughing at you. And she said that we're just doing, on this show, we're just doing Jesuit jokes.
Jesuit jokes.
Yes, because that's what we are.
That's
we're
all we
Jesuits.
Do. That's it.
Dude. I totally, yeah, Gail and JF should battle rap, and she can wear her black face, and she can even bring that velvety voiced black dude around, and he can rap over her, you know, because that seems to be her style, is get someone with an actually good voice to do it, and then you just kind of do it underneath in your meek, mousy voice. I think it works for her. Would you battle rap her, JF?
I would battle rap pretty much anyone.
Anyone? Even like...
Anyone.
Even if you knew you were going to be destroyed?
Yeah, I mean, I would love to find someone to destroy me, but I would always work to try to beat them.
Okay.
Do you want to read the the video description to this?
Yeah, let's read the video description.
Okay, I'm going to... Should I just put it up on the screen here?
Yeah, go ahead. It says...
In all caps, for the most part. Oh, no, all right.
I should explain some of the terms.
Oh, you know what? Should I? I would say start from the top.
All right. Gail has decided to leave her hood mentality. Terrance Jenkins is making his version of the Gabriel Chana Fox News Channel, which is Channel 00 on cable TV, for those of you who want to watch. It's totally there. Go check. He's wearing white face paint. Terrance explains some rap terminology to Gail. I should explain some of the terms. Paper means cash. Self-snitching and self-telling means they be showing their hood mentality by trying to buy things and staying in poverty. Going back to the watermelon means they are basically going back into slavery by sinking into debt. The shit you ball means all of the possessions you buy that you can't actually afford. Cribs be a term for houses.
Huh.
But it also be a TV show where black people show off their houses that be too expensive for them.
So this is something Terrance wrote to Gail to explain everything.
And he's a judge. So he's one of those judges that writes in all caps and Ebonics. Throw it up means to lift your hands, or to throw away money, or to throw up and vomit. He be using the term creatively here. It kinda ironically means all three at once. A lot of times, rap music says things it is against, like to make fun of it, or show how bad it is. So a rapper that doesn't like violence might say, niggas wanna do me like... Niggas wanna do like me and fuck bitches and kill niggas.
but he actually be forcing you to look at the issues, and it be so offensive that it forces people to self-evaluate. That be why they say bad words, too. It makes people stop and pause. I, Terrance Jenkins, hereby authorize Gail Cord Schuller to use the N-word when spoken as the word nigga as a brotherly or otherwise familial term of endearment. Gail highly recommends people watch Ice Cube's movie Straight Outta Compton to really understand what the hood mentality is. So Gail recommends Straight Outta Compton.
So Gail is allowed to say niggas.
Yes.
That's, yeah, okay. Well, she does have
with
permission.
The authority vested in her by Terrance Jenkins.
Who is a judge.
High judge of all black people.
Yeah. I mean, if it's been passed down from there, I mean, it's not questionable.
Certainly not. Certainly.
Any other words about it before we move on?
What can you even really say, Ben?
I don't know.
What can you even really say? Just pointing out it exists is enough. Trying to make it any funnier than it is not going to work.
Yeah.
All right.
I hope for the next video she does blackface, she's actually like outside and people react. Like, people react. Jesuit idiots react to Gail blackface.
JF, any other opinions before we move on?
Oh, I mean, Gail, we've pretty much said everything there was to say about Gail.
Yes.
All right.
There's Paul. So what are we doing? Why are we just levitating?
I don't know.
Why am I levitating?
And why is TJ naked?
What? So he cut Paul's head off.
So I have a question. Do we just not exist below the waist?
No.
Or are we buried in the ground? Or what is happening?
We don't exist, dude.
I was very confused.
We
by
exist
graphics.
In like almost like a void, like are just like our upper bodies exist.
I think whatever visual he was aspiring to, he didn't actually have the level of talent to get to, or he just didn't have the patience.
He
or
did
whatever.
Decapitate Paul and kick his head into a goal.
I mean, I understood that part. That part was done okay.
Yeah,
but what were we doing? It made no sense.
And why was there the random banana there? Like, shouldn't you be using the banana?
Yeah, like I should be like cramming it in my ass over and over again, or
like
something.
Like licking your lips as you look at the banana. Or something.
Give me
this vegan guy doesn't like you, Scotty. He's about to talk some shit.
He doesn't?
About to talk some schmack
he does not
about
like you.
You, Scotty.
Well, I love him.
Okay.
I love
he loves you.
I love you. I love everybody.
How can you talk shit about Scotty when
he loves you? Loves you.
Is he Canadian?
He loves you.
Just one question. Is he Canadian?
I think he's Australian.
Okay, then I love him. I love him.
In a pitch black room.
Someone going
you
after
Paul.
You
absolute donkey.
I didn't realize it. All right. Can we pause this? I'll
You're
explain.
You're a donkey, Paul. Yeah, I did say
I
those words.
I get this fucking question all the time. Like, I'll take
explain
them off if
it.
You want. Like, I'm just going to
oh,
be
God,
fucking
put them
my
back
eyes.
On.
Fucking let the cockhead speak, Scotty, you fat inbred. No wonder the Drunken Peasants comment section is riddled with people wanting you to be dropped from the show. Because all you do is routinely interrupt people with your handicapped
Good.
Bullshit. No one wants to watch you embarrassingly
yeah,
try to
you
imitate
know what?
TJ
this is
president.
Totally right. He's totally right about everything he's saying.
Oh, yeah?
I agree 100%.
You agree
yes.
with him?
Yes.
Huh?
He's completely right.
Oh,
okay.
Triple chin fuckwit.
My eyes are going to be watering all fucking night if I do this.
Triple chin, Scotty. How many chins you got? Let's see. One.
About three.
Two,
about three.
And I don't know if that's another
yeah,
chin.
Yeah, like, I'm so fat. You know, what can I say?
Yeah.
God, I'm just covered. I'm fucking fat bastard, dude.
Covered in fat.
I'm just covered in fat, yes.
Yep.
From head to toe.
I think I have about 98% body fat. at least.
I didn't even know there was anything other than fat.
We have to push him around in a wheelchair.
Yeah, I can barely walk.
Yeah.
If at all.
We need to push him around in two wheelbarrows, one for each bulbous ass cheek.
Yes.
Like, my eyes are super... I have really light blue eyes. I get snow blindness.
If the brightness of your monitor is causing your eyes to water, why don't you just simply reduce the brightness of your monitor? Or has saturated fat clogged your brain?
See, this guy is providing solutions.
But here's another reason Paul wears the glasses. Because he's so fucking high that a lot of times his eyes are like...
No, it's because the sun never sets in Coolsville.
Is that why, Ben?
Yes.
The sun.
Okay, guys.
Never
you know,
the sun never sets.
Before I hate on this guy, he had a perfect solution. Turn down the brightness of your monitor. I love this guy. He's a great guy.
I love him, huh?
Yo, yeah, I love him, man. He's a great guy. You know, he's a little angry, but you know what? It's just because he cares. It's because he cares.
He's not the typical vegan.
Yeah, he's like the amazing atheist of vegans, man.
Yeah, he's the amazing atheist of vegans.
He's trying to be upset.
He just doesn't like humans. That's where he draws the line. Like, animals are good. Other humans, he doesn't really seem to like many humans.
Where such a solution is unthinkable. You fucking cockhead. To me, it just seems that you're overly insecure about the way your eyes are distributed on your face. So you've decided to compensate for these insecurities by wearing these stupidly oversized glasses.
Is this guy on crack? Is he like, oversized. He does his videos like this. He's like, hey, guys, I just want to get to this. It's like, why don't you just stand still for a minute and can you work on your audio
issues?
If you're
going to rock, you should rock more slowly and back and forth. That's how it's done.
Like, you're, dude.
Maybe like this.
Not even to judge the content of your video, your audio issues are pretty bad. I mean, you could say we're morons, but I think the audio here is better, just objectively. Not that I have anything to do with the audio. I mean, that's all Ben, but just saying.
Bend over.
I don't know. I don't know if his audio is like this on purpose.
Oh, I guess
what.
That's possible.
I don't know. It sounds pretty crazy, though.
It's a style, guys.
Behavior can also be found amongst teenage girls.
Snow blindness.
Yeah, plenty of behaviors can be found amongst teenage girls. It doesn't automatically make them bad. I mean,
yeah, like teenage
breathing
girls.
Breathing isn't a behavior found in teenage girls.
They talk to people. They
go to movies.
Yeah.
They text on their phone. It doesn't mean those things are all automatically bad. It just doesn't. Teenage girls do that, you fucking idiot.
So whatever the fuck it is, like my eyes get really fucking sensitive.
Yeah, you do seem like quite a sensitive bloke, mate.
So fuck you, vegan douche.
Sensitive bloke.
Fuck this Skrillex haircutted.
Was he applauding the insults?
Oh yeah, because I'm sure you would never flub if you were doing a live podcast instead of videos.
Dude, he's.
I mean, how many jump cuts are in your fucking videos?
Yeah.
You realize every jump cut you have in this video represents you fucking up and having to cut it. I'm a YouTuber. I know why jump cuts exist, motherfucker. I mean, pretty much everyone does, but
yeah, it's just a dumb.
I'm even more aware.
It's a dumb criticism. It really is. I mean, if he doesn't agree with Paul on veganism, that's
yeah. But like, yeah.
I honestly don't even care.
Shut up.
You know,
you should care.
Who cares?
Fuck this piece of shit.
I don't care. I love.
Fuck this piece of shit.
I love him.
You love him. Huh?
Let's have a beer, Australian guy. Oh, I guess a vegan beer in your case, but I know they make vegan beer.
It's called piss.
It's called piss. Well, we'll just drink piss then.
Because I'm going to piss in his mouth.
Well, I'm not going to drink that.
Yeah, spit it out, fat boy.
Limey fucking oat bar eating flapjack never fucking know what it means. Bad dental hygiene queen worshipping fucking cockney piece of...
Yeah, I think Paul thought that he was English.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
Shit.
Oh, well.
Fucking quality insults there, mate. I suppose I shouldn't expect a lot from a person with an overall IQ equivalent to the length of his fucking hair. You fucking dickhead.
Is that, you can't fuck, it, like, artificially inseminating a cow?
Now we're watching cow porn.
Sexually assault.
Oh, my God. He's got to jerk off now.
God damn.
Unzip. Oh, yeah. Fist that fucking cow. Do it.
Can we have a gentleman's agreement?
Fist that fucking cow, mate.
Can we have a gentleman's agreement with this guy that, like, we'll ban everything, everyone will become vegan if he just gets into an airplane, goes up 30,000 feet, and jumps out without a parachute. And if he lives, we'll still all be vegans. And if he dies, we'll still all be vegans, but just...
but he has to do it.
Yeah, he has to do it. He's going to sacrifice himself for the animals. Hey, dude, you know the animal holocaust is happening right now, and we're willing to make you this offer right now.
The entire world
drunken peasants will never eat...
on board with this.
...will become vegans totally, assuredly, 100%.
No, everyone on Earth.
Everyone on Earth.
We've polled the planet. Everyone said they'd be willing to switch to veganism if you would just die. So,
well, I mean, look, there's a chance he could live.
Question.
There's a chance he could live.
I keep calling you Paul. I wish Paul was here. JF.
He could live.
Say the words you want to say.
Would it be moral to say to do what Scotty suggested, knowing that you will cause the extinction of cows and pigs? For example, if everyone stops eating meat, we will extinguish many species on Earth. Would it be moral just because we care about how they feel and how Would it be moral to stop eating meat?
Well, we offered them a deal, so I guess it is moral. I mean, we're fine with it. You know, if they all just go extinct, well, it's like, well, you know, this guy went extinct too.
It's something that vegan people don't often explore, which is that their existence, these animals, they now depend on us. They've been recruiting us for their reproductive strategy for hundreds of years. They are dependent on us. And if we stop farming them, they will die.
Well, maybe people will just farm them because they're nice.
Yeah, they'll keep them as pets, yeah. Jeff. You didn't think about that. There's going to be a lot of people with pet cows, you know? Come on.
Yeah, man. We just have cows because they're cool.
I mean, well...
Cool cow.
I mean, if you can...
I'm cool,
you know,
cow.
I guess if everyone's vegan, they wouldn't consume the animal byproducts then. So I guess, yeah, there wouldn't be milk or anything. So, I don't know. I mean,
there would still be coconut milk.
There might still be some.
And soy
but
milk.
Definitely nowhere near as many.
And almond milk. And various. Oh, there's hemp milk, too. I've had that.
You've had hemp milk? Did you
hemp
get
milk?
Did
it's
you
the
get
old
high?
Question of if you put a mind, an animal mind, into existence, you add one more conscious being in the world. At which degree of suffering would you do that? And everyone knows that every animal and every human will suffer at some point in his life. What is the amount of suffering where you say, oh, it's worth it, let's make this baby or let's make this animal? And this is not a clear, there's no clear answer. And even vegan people have not really thought about this. When is it worth to put a conscious being into existence?
Shut up, JF, your fancy thoughts.
All right.
This is too high. We're all just like, what the smart one
that
said.
That fringe, he know what he talking about, man.
He got an accent. He knows all kinds of shit.
You should have seen him breaking out with the big philosophicalness and such, man. He made me.
You're literally spouting the exact nonsense that you did in the last video. I've already understood
That's
and refuted
sexy.
Your piss poor argument. So there's absolutely no need for this rather unlettered and pointless reiteration of the previous video.
Cows are not capable of saying no when it comes to stuff like that, nor do I think.
All right, do you want to keep watching this or do you want to move on?
Stick a dick in his mouth.
Stick some meat in his mouth.
Oh. Dick is meat?
I don't. Well, no. I mean, I guess it is, but I don't think he would want to eat.
Stuck a fried cow dick in his mouth.
Okay. That's fine.
Well, the cows don't have dicks. Bull dick.
Yeah, we're dumb.
All right. Before we move on, we want to remind everyone there is a link in the description that you can use to RSVP for the meetup, which we will be having.
We have it narrowed down to two possible venues.
Yeah. So we are getting venues, or a venue. And there will be basically a way for us to, we'll actually have a PA system and shit.
Yeah, if you're coming to the meetup, you got a fucking RSVP.
Yeah, RSVP. Do it. We'll all be there. Paul will be there.
Jesus will be there. It's going to be awesome.
Pimp Monk will be there. I guess Pimp Monk's going to make out with Paul.
Okay.
Awesome.
Yeah.
They have to have, like, a piece of ham between them, though.
A piece of ham?
Yeah, they gotta, like, eat their way through the ham before they make out. It's my rules.
So we have 52 people that say that they're going for sure.
And 51 are interested?
Yeah.
Yeah, just so you guys know, there is a possibility that this date may change.
Yes.
It would only be within a day or two. Well, just a one day, actually. It would have to either be on the 13th or the 15th, but... probably going to stay on the same date. We'll just see.
Yes, we will see.
Do, 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 do. Gone.
V gone.
We had that clip from Scott Pilgrim Saves the World where he's like, you were a V gone, but now you will be gone. We could just do that every time we fucking stop talking about a vegan. And then there can be an explosion.
I want to get Vegan Gains on and have Repsy on finally.
Yeah, Repsy Nom versus Vegan Gains. We gotta do that shit. Man, because, you know, I don't know. I haven't heard back from Repsy on, though. Don't pussy out, Repsy on. Everyone needs to go harass Repsion and make sure his ass comes on here and makes up for his bitching out last time. Don't let him bitch out again, y'all. You gotta fucking put his feet to the fire. I'd be like, Repsion, what the fuck is wrong with you, bro?
That,
face your fears. Face vegan gains.
I have a video from the guy that created Cool Cat.
Yeah.
And it's him talking about his Indiegogo campaign because he's making a gun self-defense for women movie.
Sweet.
Do you want to see that?
Yeah, he's crazy.
All right.
Hi, I'm Derek Savage.
Hey, Daddy Derek, what's up?
I'm here today to talk to you about a very awesome project. But it's something much more important than that, because it's something that has actual meaning to it, and it's something that could help you save your life, and that is gun self-defense for women. Now, I've been asked several times.
Very clever title.
Now, why am I producing this project this time? And the answer is very simple. And it's because I am sick and tired of reading story after story about women being attacked, being beaten, being raped, and being murdered. And I can do something about it.
Cool Cat doesn't think that's cool!
You see,
in you have to put your hands in front of your mouth when you do that.
Safety, you know, to teach you respect and teach you about how to use a firearm, but also on gun self-defense, on how to get yourself out of a situation. You see, I got my first gun when I was about 10 years old. I've had them ever since. And I even used to be in the machine gun industry. So I guess you could say...
You were also in the stripping industry, weren't you?
Yeah, he was a male stripper.
So he was a
He wrote a book about it.
He was a male... Was he a male stripper and then he went to the machine gun industry? Or was it the other way around? I'm very curious about that.
Yeah, what makes him a self-defense expert again? Like, he was...
The same thing that made him an expert in children's movies?
Yeah, I'm just kind of like...
Which is...
Okay, you
he
know...
He appointed himself to be that?
He has really so far his qualifications seem to be he can yell and he has a poster.
Dude, I hope that gun self-defense for women is as bad as Cool Cat Saves the Kids. If it
I
is,
I love what's below the title. Look at this; it's written and for men too.
And for men too. Men too, I guess. Sure, you guys.
If you're relying on guns, don't you just need to learn how to use a gun?
Yeah, you're better off taking like an actual safety course rather than just watching this guy's probably terrible movie. But yeah. I bet you it's going to be funny.
Why don't you go learn in real life where you can actually have experience handling a weapon if that's what you want to do?
No, Scotty, you got to watch Derek. You got to watch Daddy Derek teach you.
Daddy Derek.
That's what his fucking name is in Cool Cat Saves the Kids.
Yep.
And he fucks a cat woman.
Yeah.
He's like. He's Cool Cat's dad, and he fucking is named Daddy Derek, and, you know, Cool Cat's mom is a cat who has the same costume as Cool Cat.
They're like a furry roleplay family.
Yeah, man, and like...
Well, I mean, you can respect that at least.
And, like, there's one part of the movie where he looks at the fucking female cat, and he's like, you know, I don't remember exactly what he said, but it was something along the lines of, like, you're one fine little kitty cat.
Yeah, so you're saying
like
Daddy Derek is also a fur... I always say furry, Yeah, I mean Fury. He's a Fury, yeah.
By the Furies!
I always fucking do that, but yeah, he's one of those.
I mean, he's probably not, but...
I think he is.
It's funny to imagine because...
He's definitely a furry dude. Look at him.
It makes the movie more enjoyable.
I know a little bit about this topic. And also, I'm going to take you through the CCW, the Concealed Weapons Permit. I'm a firm believer in that, and I believe that a woman has to have... all the possibilities to protect yourself in this crazy world. I mean, what is happening out there? Now, I would also like to add we have some very cool...
Let's see these reviews here. Finally, an important movie that has meaning. Linda Hopkins, Tony Award winner.
This film will save women's lives.
You can actually put this sentence on any movie ever made.
People involved with this project. And, hey,
did they say that about this movie? Because,
dude, is the fucking poster of the movie the thing he just showed him look like fucking Dirty Harry?
Hey, there's even rewards where you have a speaking role in this film.
Wow, it's your big break,
damn.
DJ.
So wait a minute, this
it's
movie
your big break.
This movie hasn't even been made, but there's quotes about it on the box.
Yeah.
Okay. That's legit.
It's like that scene in Spaceballs where they already had the movie on VHS.
Yeah, they watched it to see what they should do and stuff. Yeah. But this is the real life version of that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have these people love this movie. One's a Tony Award winner, one's an Emmy Award winner. We haven't made the movie yet, but when we do, they're going to love it.
They came back from the future.
It has meaning.
The me in the future sent them a copy to the past so I could get these quotes for my box art for this movie I'm going to make.
So is this basically his funding plea?
I wonder if he's going to show off his Van Halen signed guitar.
TJ,
again.
If he's actually doing like an Indiegogo fundraiser now, you could actually like donate enough and he'll have to put you in the movie.
Yeah. Could my speaking role be Spank Me Daddy Derek or something like that? Can we do
yes.
that?
Yes.
This All needs right. to happen.
I'm going to fucking donate to this movie getting made, man. This movie needs to happen. Everyone go donate to this movie.
Love to have you, man. And I can also get you associate producer credits. I mean, there's a lot of really cool rewards. And for all
yeah,
you...
for yeah, we got an associate producer here too. They bought their way to the associate producer position. And by the way, that was not me that fucking made it associate producer and wanted the butt in the background and shit. That was all that guy.
Was it?
Yep, he was like, yep. Yeah, I want you to credit me as associate producer with an ASS in all caps. I'm like, okay.
Cool.
Will do, man. You're the you rule ass because of the this. You got this down.
Cool Cat fans. Hey, I even got some of the Cool Cat props. You know, this is
oh shit. Fucking A, dude.
You can get fucking Cool Cat props. I mean,
they got the fucking vote for Cool Cat that little fat bully kid sprayed. I want that.
Just fucking donate, dude.
Oh man. Award of excellence.
They have the Cool Cat gun.
Yeah.
JF is, he just wants all of this shit right now, I can tell.
JF is checking his bank balance as we speak.
JF is like, salivating.
He's like, how much do I have? How much do they need?
You have any deep philosophical things to say about Cool Cat, JF?
Well, not about Cool Cat, no. I don't know much about this.
You're a fool.
The poster, the idea interesting. I mean, for women, I think that the sex specificity is not justified here. I don't see why people do. I think he's exploiting the idea that we think that women are more victims of violence, but in reality, they're at least equal, and even perhaps men are more victim of street crimes than women.
Yep. You right, JF. You know what's what.
Sort of a documentary-style film where I don't have a lot of props on this, but I got the Cool Cat stuff to give to you. And I sure hope that you come and stand with me, with us, in this very powerful and very...
You had it right the first time.
You had it right the first time.
You had it right the first time. You know, just, hey, if you want this to be your vanity project and this is what you think is the best use of your time and someone wants to give you money... I mean, they could give their money to dumber shit, so I'm fine with it.
No, they really couldn't, because this is not going to be good. This is going to be terrible. I guarantee that most of the lessons he's going to teach are going to be wrong, because he's just dumb. He's really
fucking
dumb.
But you know what? He's going to provide hours of entertainment unintentionally.
Yeah, he is.
So
that's why I want it made. I want it made because I want to see how bad it is, and it's going to be fucking terrible. Yeah. I mean, you know, it's going to be horrible
beyond
reason.
That's a foregone conclusion.
It has to be made. I so want it to be made. I can't wait to fucking watch it and laugh at its
expense. He looks, when you freeze frame this guy, he looks like so disheveled and desperate and crazy and just like, I really need to make this movie. It's like, you know, if you met this guy like at a fucking cafe, he'd be pitching you his fucking movie.
Yeah, he does look like that when you freeze frame him, but he also looks like that when he's moving. Because that's exactly what the fuck he is.
No, I mean, I know that. I'm just saying, but look, this like really drives home. I'm looking into his eyes. It's like, you know, the lion and the fucking, you know, the gazelle and the Serengeti. And you're just looking, it's like, you're fucked.
I would say we screen cap this because that is like almost a perfect expression of desperation. Screeny cap
it. It was like the picture of Paul where he's like depressed. You're like, fuck. You just see how miserable Paul is. And this is like the same thing, but for, you know, just desperation.
Get it. I love it. You could put a number of things into his hand right there, too, by the way. People. And you can, I love when people tweet the fucking results to me at Amazing Atheist and also at the Drunken Peasants official Twitter.
Yes.
I love that shit.
Project in today's time. And the one thing that I'm really asking you, right, tell all your friends about gun self-defense for women.
Their butts
are telling everyone right now.
And always remember, Cool Cat loves you, baby.
Thanks, Derek.
Cool
Daddy
Cat.
Derek.
So everyone watching, Cool Cat loves you, baby. He loves you. He loved you long.
Ben, did you know Cool Cat loves you, Ben?
Yeah, I did.
Did you know he loves you?
He told me. And he's like, oh my God, Ben, I love you.
That is how he talks. Such a charming
so
character.
So do we know if the campaign is working?
No, we don't.
No idea. If someone figures it out, let us know. Or this might be long done, too. Who knows?
No, this is new, man. I feel it.
I'm not sure. actually, I think he may have even taken this video down.
Wow.
Oh,
so sad. I wanted gun self-defense for women to happen.
All right. Let's see. Donald Trump can legally put Obama in jail for Gitmo crimes.
Sweet.
Finally.
JF's happy about that.
He's going
no, wait. No, you're wrong, Ben. He can legally butt Obama in jail.
What?
Yeah.
It's like butt, but through the...
The title is right.
Well, it went right in the video.
Common sense.
Wait, is that a picture of himself in the background?
I made
this suggestion
before.
Wait, is that a picture of him in the background, or is that some other bald black guy wearing
shades? No, that's
him.
That's him.
I think.
Wow.
Usually this guy's in his car.
I'm an egomaniacal fuck, but I don't believe I'm hanging up any pictures that are just of myself trying to look cool.
Yeah, Legally butt.
Yeah, he's got a picture of himself and then a bridge. It's like, look at this nice bridge, and me.
And now, Judge...
Both architectural marvels.
Andrew Napolitano is suggesting that whoever is elected president will have a right to have Barack Obama locked up legally. Well, he's broken the law so many other times, and he could be locked up for so many other treasonous acts, but...
Oh my God, they say this about every fucking president, man.
Yeah, Obama's committed treason. Look
you know, no president is going to have that precedent on their hands of prosecuting the president that was before them. Because they don't want that shit happening to them when they get out of office, because they know that by the time they do, there's going to be a litany of things that people can make arguments are illegal. Because it happens to every single fucking president. How many people have said, George Bush should be in jail for war crimes.
Dick Cheney,
Bill Clinton
George
should
Bush.
Be in jail for his war crimes and for, you know, lying to the country and all this other shit. I mean, like, everyone's going to have that baggage when they leave office. Whether they're a good president or a bad president or however the fuck you feel about them, there's always going to be some case that can be made, this president should be in jail for doing this. So no president is ever going to do that. Especially not Donald Trump, because you know his ass has some crazy shit planned.
Judge Andrew Napolitano has suggested that what Barack Obama did with the Guantanamo Bay release prisoners using taxpayer funded money without going through Congress is a crime punishable up to 10 years in prison.
On.
Yep, Obama needs 10 years.
The case has been made that Guantanamo Bay is not even legal in the first place. So, I mean, I don't understand. I mean, like, there's so much legal gray area going on in that whole thing that I don't see how you could possibly prosecute anybody, especially when, you know, the people he released they were never formally charged with a crime.
JF, how do you feel about offshore military prisons?
He's been in one.
I'm definitely against it.
He was raised
in one
of those.
If there's one thing I hate about America, it's the international interventions and military interventions. I like everything else about America from the
get out of our country! How dare you criticize anything about us! Get out!
No, I mean, totally
it's
right.
It's clearly a bunch of places in the world where rights don't exist or they are being stepped on every day.
Oh, they commonly take people overseas and interrogate them. And there's people overseas they interrogate. They
extraordinary.
And they don't give them any rights.
It'd be cool.
Oh, how I would love to see that, Mr. Trump. If you...
I'd love to see that, Mr. Trump.
Become
so
elected
as a
president,
boner
I don't think
for Trump just like fucking taking Obama and it's like seize him, you know, like Obama's like, you know, he's passing the torch on to Trump. It's like, you know, Trump's inauguration and Obama's like seized. It's like, Obama, you're now in fucking prison.
Finally.
This is like his fantasy.
I don't think any of the others would even consider this. But I do feel,
you know, Trump should add that to his campaign though. She'd be like, I'm going to imprison Obama.
Yeah, the minute I'm commander-in-chief, Obama's in prison. You know what? He can actually detain Obama for life.
Yeah, he needs to make that part of his campaign platform. Get him even more votes. Because every time he says something crazy, the crazier he gets, the more votes he gets. So he just needs to go full Trump with it. I'm going to put Obama in jail. Then I'm going to make him build the wall. It's going to be huge.
So Obama by himself is going to build the wall.
Huge.
That Donald Trump would consider having Barack Obama locked up for all the crimes he's committed against the American people. Just look at the things that Barack Obama has done. He once threatened to literally defund the military unless Guantanamo Bay was shut down. Now think about that.
No, that never happened. You're insane. Also, that is also not a crime, but it also didn't happen. So it's like kind of a moot point. He's the president.
Oh, every Republican says we're gutting the military. It always happens.
He said this guy didn't even say we're going to gut it. He said we're going to just defund it. Now, if it happened, we could say that's a bad policy decision. Still not a crime. Right. Down the military.
That's
unless
hyperbole.
We close Guantanamo. If Obama said that, his ass would have been impeached.
We have men and women overseas, and your president says, unless you close down Guantanamo Bay, I will literally defund you in the people.
Down shit. Is that what he's talking about? I don't know.
If he's talking about that was the Republicans. And
well, I mean, he's never going to blame Republicans.
Suffer the consequences. Our military people. This is your leader.
No. I don't know where you got that
information. Is he talking about, like, the budget?
I mean, even that budget shutdown wouldn't have really affected the military too much.
Well, some people weren't paid. I actually do believe, like, people in the military were not paid.
But, yeah, that was because the Republicans were fucking being obstinate.
Yeah.
It was nothing to do with Obama. They basically held the entire country hostage and said, unless we get what we want, we're not going to approve a new budget. So how is that Obama?
Yeah, because the Republicans wanted to cut domestic spending. Yeah.
But there was never any talk of, like, we're just going to defund the military. No politician on either side of the aisle has said that unless they're running for, like, the fucking socialist Green Party or some shit. And even then, probably not, really. Yeah.
Not only has he threatened to defund us for not releasing all of these terrorists from Guantanamo Bay.
He keeps sounding like he's saying Guantanamo Bay.
Guantanamo!
That's who he's calling terrorists.
Guantanamo!
Guantanamo!
Geronimo!
Geronimo. Geronimo
who
Bay!
Who told you they were terrorists?
Yeah, I mean, like, the thing is, if they were terrorists,
they're all terrorists.
We should be able to charge them as terrorists and try them.
Nope.
Why can't we do that? It's because we don't have good evidence that they are terrorists. We're just like, we suspect you of being a terrorist, and
I'm pretty
rather
sure
than proving it, we're just going
to
lock
you. Well, they wanted to try some people in New York, but then there was just a huge shitstorm surrounding it. So it's like, never mind, just
because
keep them
Americans
there.
I've heard that I've heard that we've held people there that we would consider minors also.
Well, you know, those fuckers, they want to kill us, Ben. What do you want to expect? You want to treat them with dignity and humanity?
Well, we wouldn't put them in a prison with adults here, but offshore we would put.
Hey, Ben, the other prisoners need someone to rape, okay?
Look, Ben, do you want people to be safe or you want people to be just killed in the streets? Look at Paris, Ben. Ben wants Paris to be every street in America, anywhere in the world.
That is Ben.
Yeah, that's me.
And so does JF. Fucking
JF, he didn't say anything. He clearly agrees with Ben. Clearly agrees
with
Ben.
Frenchy piece of shit.
He's a shifty Jew.
Yeah. I don't trust JF.
Why would you? He's from Canada.
That shit he said during the animal segment didn't even make no sense, man. Didn't even make sense. You're fucking crazy, JF.
JF's on a power trip, dude.
Why are you always fucking with me, JF? Come on, man. You're laughing. See how evil you are? What kind of person just laughs in another person's face? You're just a real piece of shit, JF. I wish you wouldn't speak, but then I wish you would, you know? When you're too quiet, but then every time you open your mouth, it's like you just say something evil.
I mean, and JF is a legitimate voice actor.
What do you want?
Do a voice, JF. You're a voice
actor. What was it? You did a goblin or something in a game? Like a French... What was it?
Yes, I did a goblin. I did a goblin. Dragon.
Yeah, and a dragon. You did a goblin, like in the ass or something?
JF does goblin.
Never.
Live on
YouTube.
Doesn't
matter. Just fucking do a goblin voice.
A goblin voice. I'm not Make super it say good at something English. Let's do it in French.
Do it in French. We don't care.
Yeah, French is fine.
Ah, ça fait mal. Can you say as a goblin, look, as a goblin, I want you to say in French, I want to take a shit on this guy's head.
Okay, let me try. Let me process this in my head.
I would like to.
in French.
To chier sur la tête.
Yeah. That's awesome. Thanks, JF.
The best part is this guy doesn't even know what you're saying. He's just going to be like, huh?
I love
it. It's been proven time and time again. You can look at case after case. These people leave Guantanamo Bay and go right back to the killing field. I mean, one of the men was supposedly a bodyguard to Osama bin Laden. He bragged about killing Osama bin Laden and lets his bodyguard go. Now, I want you to briefly take a listen to your president speaking at his outrage again about the Syrian refugees coming in, and then we'll...
So when they don't like Obama, then he's like definitely president. But some of them are even say, "Oh, he was born in Kenya, so he can't be president legally." So now this guy is definitively saying, "Oh, he's definitely born in Hawaii. He's definitely president, so he can be charged with these war crimes." Basically.
Well, you know, if he's born in Kenya, he should be charged with defrauding the American people and executed summarily.
Visit this and other things after this.
Wow, this is great, man. I love how you captured this
in stunning 1080p.
You know, you recorded it on your TV and then you went and grabbed your camcorder and fucking filmed the fucking footage with terrible audio and a shaky hand. I love that, man. That's just like so high tech.
The rhetoric around refugees suggesting that we should only allow Christians in or...
You believe it's queer? Look how he's sitting there with his knees crossed.
You believe it's queer? Look how he's sitting with his knees crossed.
Oh, look.
What a fucking queer.
Right next to a damn Canadian, it looks like.
Look at this shit. JF, can you believe this fucking queer Obama with his fucking leg crossed? That fucking queer, huh?
I don't think that Obama is queer.
No, what?
Definitely a queer.
Hey,
look at him.
Fucking JF. How will you explain why his leg is crossed then, JF? Explain that to me.
I think I've seen him do that a lot. It's just the Obama pose when he's relaxed.
No, it's his gay pose when he's fucking trying to conceal his big faggoty boner.
Right?
What?
He's with the Canadian Prime Minister right there. That's Justin Trudeau.
Yeah, no wonder he's got a big fucking boner, man. Justin Trudeau is fucking cute, man. Obama's got a big fucking heart on. That's why his leg's crossed.
Yeah, and Obama's kind of looking at it, too. He's like, damn.
Yeah, he's looking over it. Look, you can see him in this fucking still shot checking Justin Trudeau's.
He's like, damn, I didn't think he'd be this attractive. Damn.
Look at him. He's staring right at his dick.
He is. I mean,
it's clear.
Video don't lie.
Who's the new boyfriend?
See, even he sees it.
Yo, new boyfriend.
You gotta be condescending like we're supposed to listen to him.
Yeah, well, you just told us to listen to him. That's what you said. You said, like, let's take a listen to what the president has to say. And then you start filming, like, and talking over him and be like, you expect us to listen to you? Fuck you.
Yeah, I know. It's like,
fucking queer, leg crossed. What the fuck? Fucking queer ass faggot.
Oh, look at his flamboyant hand gestures, TJ.
I'm Obama!
Alienates Muslim Americans.
You don't alienate them.
Don't alienate them.
This guy actually is watching a fucking football game. Don't alienate. Yo, no. It's like, dude, Obama can't hear you.
He can. How can you say it doesn't alienate Muslim Americans? I mean, of course it does. I mean, even if the idea of, like, let's keep Muslims out had merit, even if I accepted, like, maybe we should, maybe it's come to that, it still would obviously alienate Muslim Americans. I mean, are you fucking kidding me? Of course it would. Any group would feel like any fucking group, and it doesn't matter who you are, you would feel fucking alienated if your group of people was like condemned to come to America. Like if it was like no atheists can come to America unless they're already here, I'd be like, that's bullshit. Of course I would be. So, yeah, I mean, what do you mean it wouldn't alienate them? Of course it would fucking alienate them, you retard.
Well, you know, honestly, just banning atheists or Muslims, it doesn't really go far enough. You also need to open the atheist internment camps to make sure you're keeping a good eye on all the people who proclaim themselves
atheists.
Just
send them to Gitmo. We're fond of that anyway.
No, you guys are going to be sent to Texas, and, like, a bunch of rednecks are going to, like, beat you and shit and, like, prod you with cattle prods and shit.
Neat.
Take good care of you.
The entire world of 1.6 billion Muslims...
Look at this.
An enormous recruitment tool.
A recruiting tool.
Organizations like ISIS.
Wow.
Look at the smugness of this.
I like that. Wow. I can't believe that. It's like,
I mean, I don't really like this whole recruitment tool argument where it's like we can't do anything because, you know, if we do the wrong thing, our enemies might use it to recruit more. Like, you know, we shouldn't be thinking of, like, PR, how we need to appear in PR to make people not join fucking ISIS, you know? But, yeah, I'm sure it has been used as a fucking recruitment tool. I mean, why wouldn't you? If there was some illegal prison where a bunch of people are being held and it happens to be people that are similar to you in some way, yeah, that's probably going to be something that gets you outraged. If you're a Muslim and most of the people in Guantanamo Bay are Muslim, you're going to be like, that's fucked up. They're being held there without trial or charge. Of course you're going to be like, man, I mean, to take up arms and radicalize against the West and shit.
The funny thing is that Muslim countries like Saudi Arabia, like, are pretty much the same way. You're just in prison. You don't know what your charge is, and that's it. It's like, oh, you're in prison now.
Yeah, I mean, but that's like their entire country. At least we.
I mean, I understand that America
put it in some fucking.
I'm glad there's a distinction between the other countries, like in America, where we do have some sort of a legal system. But, I mean, at the same time, it's like, I agree with you. It's like, you know, you can't say, oh, everything, because, I mean, everything a terrorist group is going to use, of course, is going to be propaganda. Oh, look, they bombed this hospital. They're evil.
And here's the problem. I mean, we always pass these new laws and shit to catch terrorists, but they never end up being used against terrorists. They always just end up getting used against the American people.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's always used, like, most of the shit the Patriot Act passed has just been used to fuck with, like, you know, common criminals, like drug dealers and, you know, shit like that.
What about the stingrays? You know what I mean? Like, just, like, all these means of tracking people, which, you know, pretty much would seem like, this seems illegal. It's like, no, it's not illegal. They can just spy on you and do whatever they want. It's fine.
It's all good.
You're suspected of a crime, so if you weren't suspected of a crime, there'd be nothing to hide. It's like, well, if you catalog all my information, you can at a later date decide, oh, what you did was illegal. So now, because we have all this information on you, you're a criminal. I mean, there's so many fucking ways that this data can be used.
And TSA, they haven't fucking caught any terrorists. They just catch drug smugglers.
Yeah, remember they blamed, like their line's going so slow because you stupid-ass fucking passengers want to get on a fucking plane. It's like, well, no shit, that's why we're fucking here.
No, I waited in a fucking TSA line for like an hour and 20 minutes. And the line was so fucked up and disorganized, and they kept rerouting us to other parts of the line. And like, I'd almost be to the front of the line, and then they'd put me in another line. It's like, fuck. And finally, when I got to the end, I heard one of these TSA guys say, you need to be helpful, folks. A lot of the reason for this delay is people aren't helping us. It's like, what? Our job is to help you? Fuck you. I don't even think this fucking security measures are even... They shouldn't even fucking exist. This is fucking retarded.
They're all ineffectual. It's been tested by the FBI. You can go look it up. It's tested all the time. They miss bombs. They miss guns. There's some ways to fool it. It doesn't fucking work. The only thing that works is reinforcing the cockpits. That's it. Oh, you have to have a boarding pass to get through security. People can go into Photoshop, create a boarding pass, and get on a fucking plane, get past all that security. I mean, and you can bring a bomb. So anyone has this fucking illusion, oh, no, this is safe, it's bullshit.
Yeah, all you're doing is just fucking causing unnecessary delay, slowing everybody fucking down. But it's, you know, most Americans support it because they just want to feel safe. They don't give a shit. They just want the illusion of fucking safety in a world that they know goddamn well, or they should, is not fucking safe. Fuck them. Fuck America. Fuck this guy. Fuck JF.
Wait. I mean, look at how much disdain he has for Christians and the disdain he has for the American people. He's never this outraged when the Christians are being killed, when Americans are being killed. He was never this angry when the folks in Benghazi died. He was never.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Time to move on.
Yeah.
Fuck this guy.
It's funny that this guy is in a room and he has the solution to everything. He has the solution to international diplomacy. Obama is he's the one who has detected that Obama is a criminal. I still haven't seen any crime there.
No, this guy has got it all figured out. And you go on the internet, you'll realize very quickly that everyone has the solution to every problem.
TJ.
Yes.
Do you want to play the video? Remember the video I told you about?
Nope.
All right. Sorry, we just had to have a huddle for a second there.
Remind TJ of what's going on.
Yeah. Yeah, cure TJ's dementia for a moment.
Where am I? Oh, this is strange.
You know.
I'm in a little box in the corner of that screen. That's weird.
He's only exaggerating a little bit.
He's a masked man. He's going to rob me.
Watch how easy it is to manipulate TJ. Hey, TJ.
Yes?
You know what I can really go for right now?
What?
A fucking chocolate chip.
Oh, I'm getting one. Fuck that. You can't even say those words. You can't fucking.
See how fucking
now.
Easy it is?
It's his fault. It really
all I have to do is one sentence. Hey, it's like, hey, TJ, want a chocolate chip? Oh, my God, I need one.
Oh, come on. You know.
I'm not getting one.
At any given time.
I'm not getting one.
The line between me getting a shake and not getting a shake is razor thin, and all it takes is someone saying the word.
Here we go. I told TJ about this, and he got pissed off.
I did?
Yeah.
Sweet. Maybe I'll get pissed off.
See,
again.
I told you, he doesn't even remember anything.
There's a million arguments going on in TJ's head at all times, yeah. So.
Well, hello there, my delicious.
Ah, oh, this fucking pile of shit.
Hello.
You asked that you wanted to see, like,
fuck you.
You've got nature in the background of my videos, so you've got
thank, well, you know what? Thank you. That's very
you're
nice.
You're fucking happy now.
Yes, I am.
Now with
happy.
That unpleasantness out of the way.
Now do a zoom in and a close-up of like a of piece day. Of dog shit.
What business do
well,
we
I
have?
Well, I guess your
here?
Face will do.
Well, I'm here to talk to you about my latest fucking appearance.
Yeah, do it.
On the Drunken Peasants podcast.
And thank you for your appearance.
Which, for those who don't know, is...
Yeah, man.
And
now this is his latest appearance.
His latest appearance was on a private show,
yeah,
actually.
Well, before this.
Yeah, before this.
And that's what he's talking about, right?
He's talking about that, yes.
Yeah, what a pile
which,
of shit.
Which is interesting because I really don't think he's one of our patrons. I mean, just something about him, I don't know.
The Amazing Atheist, yeah. TJ.
Hi,
fucking piece of shit.
Sort of secondary vehicle, as it were.
Secondary
he
vehicle.
He has two, although on this occasion, only one.
He's like saying that this show is my, like, shitty beater car that I go around in when I don't want to get my good car dirty. It's his secondary vehicle.
One of his pet gimp monkey creatures.
Oh
man. Get back in the box, Ben. Get back in the box, Scotty. I'll be coming
this
to insert your guys' butt plugs later. Yeah, we're
pretty
much just
I don't understand why people do the walking videos like this.
If my first video was a walking video. My first video was a walking video, man. It was pee pacing around in my garage.
You should take the time to sit and explain it to me.
Why do I have to sit?
Where is he going?
He's walking back to his house.
Hey, he's walking, dude.
He walked to the woods. He started recording this video. Now he's walking back to
his house. He just
wants
to get some exercise and make a video.
He
what's wrong with
on.
That? Look at him. He needs it. Yeah.
It's wrong on the sound.
It's what?
It's wrong for the audio. It's wrong for the video. It shakes.
It's an artistic
style. It's uncomfortable
style.
To look at. It's not an artistic style.
But
yes, it is.
Here's the thing, though, JF.
It's art. You don't get to determine
what
art is, JF.
No, no, JF, though, you have to realize that regardless of how this is presented, this guy's words are not going to be impactful in any way, so it really doesn't matter what he does. Like, if he was recording on a camera that couldn't even, like, it was too, like, the wind was so strong in the mic that you couldn't even hear a word he was saying, it would actually be an improvement. That's like the level of
dude, if you had a fucking Hollywood film crew filming this, it still wouldn't be impactful.
Yeah, you have like Spielberg and Zemeckis working on this guy looking good. You know, Ben's like, yeah, let's move on, come on.
Take the piss. And that's fine. You know,
it's cool.
A tried and tested format. Now, I'm not bringing this up to say, like, I was on his podcast fucking thing, because it's got the third or fourth time I've been on it.
Fifth now, bitch!
And, it's interesting, though, TJ.
Yeah, it is interesting. It is interesting, but you're not interesting is the thing.
You were able to use my video,
yeah,
and indeed videos, as I've been on before,
mm-hmm.
Free of charge, because, again, that's fine, because you're doing, you know...
fair use. It's used for purposes of commentary and criticism, and it is transformative in nature. So that's why I can do it.
Yep.
So, yeah, it is interesting. Not really pertinent to anything, but interesting. Maybe it will be pertinent in a second. I don't know. Let's see what he says.
Yeah.
Fair use. You're commenting on it and all the rest of it. That's fine.
Right. Yes. But, correct.
Oftentimes, people aren't able to do that with your videos because you've sold the rights to your videos, haven't you?
Well, actually, Amazing Atheist channel is no longer on a network. I would not recommend anyone join a network. I think they're a scam. And
yeah, don't do it.
Yeah. But, I'm no longer on that. I'm done with that. That's one of the reasons why, in fact, because that's bullshit. So, anybody should be able to use my videos for any reason, as long as it's fair use. If they try to steal my videos, I might have something to say about that, but if they want to...
Yeah.
You never filed any of those, any claims.
I've never filed a claim against anyone for using my content.
Basically, just put your commentary over it and make it your own, and then you can use the video.
Right. And if anything has ever been flagged for doing that, it has not been me. It's been some other system somewhere else. I don't have... Just because I control the channel doesn't mean I'm always holding the reins of every little thing that happens. You know, YouTube is a strange beast, all right? But, I've never filed any sort of dispute or complaint about anyone using any clip for any reason as long... I don't care. If your fucking whole contention is I'm a piece of shit and I should die and you have a bunch of clips, why? And you just make the most savage, brutal, hate-filled video in the world... I might not like it, but I'm not going to fucking try to get it taken down.
Yeah, I actually remember one time you did. That was because the guy was like, I'm going to resell your book.
Well, that was a totally different reason.
Yeah, that was the
only
time.
That wasn't for using my clips. That was for trying to steal something that I created and sell it for his own profit.
So one time in 9 years in a totally different case. Like, yeah, you're not fucking taking people's videos down. I mean, like, I know you. You don't even give that much of a fuck about the responses.
Hell, I think any publicity is good publicity.
A fucking corporation. Which, you know, comes to the general kind of, fuck the corporations, man. Bullshit that you sort of try and spew forth as if you're actually some sort of...
What? I spew fuck the corporations shit? I use all kinds of corporations. Did you see my face light up when I saw there was Oreos? It's made by Nabisco, that's a corporation. YouTube's a corporation. My clothes were made by corporations. Tons of stuff I use on a daily basis are made by corporations.
Movies that you watch.
Right, I just went and fucking saw Star Wars. I loved it. It was made by the fucking biggest, most fucking probably one of the most abusive corporations out there. I mean, Disney, you could make some fucking serious complaints against their business practices. Plenty of people have. I still saw the fucking movie. I still support it. So I'm not this big anti-corporatist that you seem to be portraying me as. What I resent is the corporate encroachment in politics and how people in America seem to think that corporations should just be subjected to this laissez-faire, they can pollute as much as they want and they can fucking exploit people and it's all well and it's all good because it's in the name of business. I don't buy into that bullshit. But I'm not against the idea of a fucking corporation. Are you a fucking retard? Have you not listened to a word I've ever said, but you're going to try to criticize me nonetheless?
Anti-establishment figure. Whereas actually you're... You're more than happy to ride the corporate cock all the way to the money shot.
Yeah, I am. That's why I couldn't possibly be against corporations. If I was explicitly like, fuck corporations in all things and all times and all places, then you'd have a point. But I'm not, so you don't.
And that might seem like I'm poisoning the well.
No, it just seems like you're misinformed.
Very relevant in a moment. Because
oh, God.
I'll leave a-
so your big relevant point isn't even true. That's pretty sad.
Link to... the video in question, the Drunken Peasant podcast thing.
Yep.
Although it was actually on private last time I looked, so you might not actually be able to view it, but it doesn't really matter, because it's a pile of shit.
It's a pile of shit.
Spoiler, it's a pile of shit.
Says the guy holding a shaky cam walking around in the middle of some ugly-ass barren woods with bad mic quality spewing mistruths.
So you do recognize that's bad quality.
Yeah, of course. It's bad quality, but it's also there's a terrible quality of what he's saying. He's not accurate. He's not even describing things accurately. He's not describing my positions accurately.
Also, making unfounded allegations like you sold your entire library to a corporation. It's like, no, they were using the content ID system. You had control over it.
He's also talking about a private show, which is not really.
Yeah, he didn't pay for it. He's not a fucking patron.
Well, and it's us getting drunk and acting foolish anyway.
Yeah, that's the whole point of those.
Right.
You know, so just silly shit. Yeah, I mean, you didn't pay for our show. You certainly didn't have the right to link to it. You know, because of your bullshit, we're actually changing the way we release our private shows in the future. And you're an asshole, and you don't know what you're talking about, and you're a shitty video maker, and you probably should just quit YouTube because this is never going to go anywhere. These wheels are always going to be spinning in the mud for you. And rest assured, this is your last DP appearance. I promise. The end.
You said that at AIU.
Oh.
And you came back to it.
Well, we'll see. I'm not a man of my word, and I would never claim to be.
Yes.
No! But I don't want to play him again. It's really up to Ben, though. Ben decides. But I say we never play him again. Fuck him.
Okay.
He's a pile of shit.
Okay. You've made your feelings clear.
Oh, here we go. Haven't played one in a while.
The return!
Yeah, haven't played one in a while.
When you get a chance, know what you think. Radio, make sure.
Oh,
hello,
yeah.
Ladies. Keen from God
Brett
TV Radio. Make
God
sure you check
TV
out my gaming channel, Games You Love. And when you get a chance, check
right
out
now,
my brother's YouTube channel where he does rock and roll
guitar.
Music for you.
It's
subscribe
really
to him and let him know what you think. When you get a chance, also check out my other YouTube channels, Brett Keen Superstar, as well as God TV Radio.
How many channels do you need?
God TV Radio.
Like, he's not a success on YouTube. The reason people have multiple channels is because, like, maybe, hey, they have one really popular channel. It's like, I want a vlog channel. It's like, you don't need a bunch of channels.
You need a secondary vehicle.
Well, you're not even successful at one.
He wants, he just figures the more channels he has, the more chance one will be a success.
Games you love.
Terrible reasoning,
Did we respond to a video, what was like, 2 or 3 weeks ago, where he was like, I'm done with all of this, and this water-headed fucking idiot is back? Just back for more, Brett, huh? It's like you feel like it's like fucking taking candy from a baby. It's just like, come on, Brett, you're really going to do this? You're really going to do this to yourself again? You're going to humiliate yourself again? Okay, Brett, go ahead and do it.
And when you get an opportunity, check out my official website. A lot of exclusive good stuff on there you probably never have seen on GodTVRadio.com. Also, follow me on Facebook and Twitter.
No.
And if you want to donate to the channel, you can do that and support it by becoming a Patreon.
Oh, my God. I'm just going to donate
today
my
we're
entire
talk
paycheck.
About entertainment.
What minute marker
we're
is this?
Talk about
he's
going
to talk about
what
entertainment.
It is to be a
Hold
character.
On. I want to know what minute marker this is.
To make
I don't know.
It popular on YouTube. How
I
far
I wonder how long it took
to
him to get through all this bullshit before he actually even starts saying anything.
Maybe I would like say probably
like 2.5 minutes, 3 minutes,
including his intro. Yeah, like 2 or 3 minutes.
Just fucking talk, Jesus.
I was talking to a
he doesn't have anything to
YouTube
say.
Atheist yesterday.
Yeah, I was talking.
His show
to
was
him.
Called The Oddcast or something like that.
Okay,
and. Apparently, he is a supporter of the Amazing Atheist. He's made it clear that he doesn't agree with the Amazing Atheist committing scams or anything. He's probably not an endorser of sticking a banana up your ass either.
Yeah, thank God.
Is that
I get a lot of
French vanilla situation going on there, Brett?
Brett, why do you constantly crack on the Amazing Atheist for that?
That's because I have no life and I just want to blame TJ for all my problems.
Look, Brett, you know, it's like you've played this card. It's like TJ stuck a banana up his ass. And this is me saying this, Brett, which I'll make fun of this motherfucker till the end of time. But you have fucking played this card out as far as it can fucking go. You've played it out so fucking hard that it's like not even a relevant insult. It's like, now it's like, come on, Brett, why do you care about TJ's ass that fucking much? Just really, what? Just come clean and be like, I am in love with TJ. I just wish I was fucking TJ. Just say it, Brett. Just come on.
Why do you constantly joke about the fact that he penetrates his own anus with bananas? What's so funny about that you have to bring that up so much? Well, interestingly enough, I noticed that whenever talking to Drunken Peasants fan about this particular topic, the subject,
particular.
I noticed that they try to defend the Amazing Atheist anal fury by
stating that. Why does he even need to be defended?
He's an entertainer.
Why does he even need to be anal fury?
No one needs
who
to
cares?
Defend you.
The Amazing Atheist in Anal Fury
who
2.
Fucking cares?
The Banana's Revenge.
If TJ told me tonight I'm going to go do the same exact thing, I'd be like, I don't even give a shit. It's your fucking life. It's your ass, not mine.
I'm going to stick 2 bananas up my ass next time. 2.
He's a character. He plays a part that he's not
get
really
get the money
TJ
back, Kirk. TJ!
He's some kind of other person whenever he's making his videos. And even TJ has pushed this idea. Even Paul's Ego, which
Paul's
is a guy
ego.
Who's in his 30s, describes that the reason why the Amazing...
Okay,
what does that
us,
have to do with anything?
All of us are in our 30s except for Scotty.
Yeah, but what does him being in his 30s have to do with anything?
He's a man in his 30s, Scotty.
I don't know.
He's in his
is
fucking 30s.
Is he describing... is Brecky describing Paul like a suspect about 6'1", 255, white male in his 30s? Like, what's going on here?
Yeah, he's profiling him.
He's in his 30s. He should know better because he's in his 30s.
Ain't you stuck a banana up in his ass is because... He goes on to tell me about nerve endings around the asshole and how it stimulates and pleasures him. And then I realize right then and there that, wow, what a sheep. This guy is actually defending why another man sticks bananas up his ass.
Seriously, if someone enjoys sticking a banana up their ass, how is that your problem at all? Like, I don't get it.
There are places in the world where you pay people to stick bananas into parts of their bodies. Who cares?
I didn't get paid.
Yeah, he didn't even get fucking paid.
People are making ad revenue off of it right now.
So is he. Brett Keane's making at least 30 cents off this video.
And I mean, he's talking about ancient fucking history as far as the internet's concerned. It's like he's dredging shit up.
What do you think Brett Keane does with like the checks he gets? You know.
Oh, like the $100 he gets every like 5 or 6 months.
Yeah.
I assume he probably just goes and blows it like he goes to like Golden Corral or something and just like fucking gorges himself. Like it's like one time out, like Brett's gotta treat Brett, right?
Now, I do believe that if it's your body, if it's what you want to do.
Oh, now hold on. Now he's saying, well, if it's your body, do what you want to do.
Okay.
And why does he care?
Bible tells me in the book of Revelations. Let evil men do evil things. Let disgusting, wicked people do what disgusting.
Okay, I mean,
disgusting, evil,
disgusting.
How is it evil to do it to yourself?
Yeah, if I was like, if I went up to people on the street
because
who didn't
TJ
want a banana up their
because
ass,
the sin is in his heart,
and just like pulled down their pants forcibly and jammed a banana up there, and Brett was like, "I have a problem." I think everyone would be like, "Yeah, that's true."
So we've been listening for 3 minutes.
Don't even use the Bible as... Oh, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Well, basically all we have is, well, it's disgusting because it's disgusting because it's disgusting. So we've been listening 3 minutes of turning around and not explaining why is he finding it disgusting.
Because he wouldn't do it.
People do. But listening to full-grown
I don't even know that.
Adults... actually defend someone sticking a banana up their ass makes you realize right
they're,
away
they're defending
that
it
there's no
because
critical
they like TJ and they're talking to you and you're of course bringing this up for the 1 billionth time,
you know.
But then when they defend it, you're mad that they're defending it. It's like, why are you defending it? It's like, because you're attacking that him on that position.
I think the next time we talk about Brett Keane, I'm going to get Skype set up where we can call phone numbers and we'll call Brett Keane's phone number. See how he's doing.
See what he's up to.
Or at least leave a message.
There's no rationality. There's no logic with these people.
None.
And again, no, I'm going to remind you all that
yeah, there's you're a clear rationale.
Get a rational explanation. It's just there's some.
Well, I'm sure there was a clear rationale from TJ.
There was a rational reason.
He wanted to stick it up his ass.
The rational. Yeah.
It's so funny because before that, everyone thought about the Ray Comfort thing, how he said a banana is the atheist's worst nightmare. And then it turns out there's a video of TJ, you know, plowing his own asshole.
I fulfilled his prophecy. But it wasn't my worst nightmare, though. It was a pleasant dream, a pleasant little jaunt so to Banana Land.
He just got that part of it wrong.
That was the only time in my life I've ever stuck a banana up my ass, though. I tried previously, but they were all too soft. That was the first.
You need to get them green, right?
Yeah, they got to be a little green. You know, that's the key.
You just try to shove rotten. Oh God,
not rotten. You know, they're just a little soft.
You got to get a star fruit next.
Yeah, you know, we're working our way up to pineapple.
I keep getting told that this is what characters and comedians of YouTube do. This is a part of the entertainment in order to get in.
This was not part of entertainment.
It was not part of the entertainment. It wasn't even supposed to really be released.
Yeah, it was leaked by a third party.
I mean, it got incorporated in the entertainment because what are you going to fucking do? But it wasn't like part of the entertainment. Although some people have speculated that I did it for attention, so... Apparently, it was a good career move. I need to start doing more shit like that.
Use and make money. But, you know, just because someone plays a gimmick or a character doesn't necessarily mean that you get away with doing heinous shit or stupid stuff. I'll give you an example. Okay. There was a man...
I'll give you a better example. There was a man named Brett Keane... who has gone through literally dozens upon dozens of channels because he basically refuses to deviate from the same behavior that has fucked him time and time and time and time again. And it's amazing to us all watching him trying again and again to restart a YouTube career that has been dead for 8 fucking years. 8 years it has been since you were actually a relevant YouTuber. And it's sad that you can't let go of it, and it's even more sad that you can't even learn from the lessons that you've been taught literally dozens of times. It's amazing to me how you haven't adapted one iota. Yeah, that's pretty much the story of you. So, the end. You know, that's pretty much, that's the best example of some fucking buddy thinking they can get away with shit they actually can't.
He referred to himself as Pee Wee Herman a while back.
Oh, God.
Pee Wee Herman
was
doing
a Pee Wee
show
Herman.
That a lot of children were watching. A lot more extraordinary and a lot more extravagant than the Amazing Asshat does. But
that's true. Pee Wee did have a pretty elaborate show.
I thought it was awesome.
The Amazing Asshat.
Yeah, it was a giant acid.
Dude,
it was a giant acid trip of a show.
Brett Keane tried like a 1999 burn on you. The Amazing Asshat.
The Amazing Asshat. He's an asshat, guys.
Nonetheless, it was a show that children were watching. They were being taught, and it was called Pee-wee's Playhouse.
Well, it was not really an educational show.
Yeah, it was pretty much sheerly for entertainment. They weren't really being taught much of anything.
There was no drinking or drugs and things like that or bullying behavior. But it was clear that the moment that you start watching the first 5 minutes of Pee-wee's Playhouse, that it was ridiculous. There wasn't no logical, rational thinking. You could not expect any kind of free thought. And to be honest with you, I don't understand why so many atheists actually think they're smart anyway. Just because you claim that you don't believe in something, that doesn't automatically mean that you're super intelligent and you're better than everybody
else. Who's made that claim?
Straw man.
Yeah, who's made that claim?
I'm smart because I don't believe in God.
Atheism means smart.
Once again, if anyone was ever guilty of that, it would be Brett. I mean, that was the whole reason he was an atheist. I mean, he was like the dumbest atheist there was. I remember people even back in the day said that. And that's not just like some revisionist history shit I'm saying.
Zero self-awareness.
He's going to bring up that video that you made about him.
What video I made about him?
The video that you made like praising him.
Oh, okay. That video.
TJ wishes that one would just go away.
Yeah, I wish it would die.
Everybody out there who actually believes in something. But a lot of stupid asses believe that about themselves. They believe that if they claim to be a part of the in crowd of atheism, this somehow makes them smart.
What's the in crowd?
Yeah, I don't even know if atheism has an in crowd.
All right, let's do the fucking handshake, man.
We don't hang out with anybody else.
Oh, yeah. The official atheist intelligence handshake, which you guys do not know because you are not smart.
I'm going to take a look at this letter.
There's a letter?
That we didn't open last time on the mail segment because it was so small. Hey, it's you as a chick, Scotty. Okay. And then it's Ben as a chick. And then it's me as a chick. I guess. It doesn't even look like us, really, but... Yeah, everyone should hold theirs up to their camera. Yeah. We're some fucking anime-esque chicks.
Let's see.
So, why is there no Brett Keen fan art?
So, Ben has like a whimsical one. Okay, I look angry. And TJ looks like a slut.
Oh. It says, "Dear Drunken Peasants, enclosed are three illustrations of the peasants as hot anime babes. You each get one. For some time now, I've been wanting to draw these three characters, so it was fun to project to try and see what your anime versions would look like. And I know that Beyond Fear already did this, so I'll let you guys be the judge as to who did a better job. Well, they're both good. Anyways, thanks for all the free entertainment, a poor starving artist. P.S. I'm also probably your one and only longtime feminist watcher. So if you guys are still looking for a feminist to come on your show, feel free to email me." And then her email is on the back of the thing. So we have a feminist who drew us as chicks wanting to come on.
Hmm.
I see.
But,
I
yeah.
I talk to him.
Do you want to talk?
Yeah, bring him.
I don't know if it's a him. Time. I think it's a girl.
Is it?
I'm not sure.
We don't know.
Doesn't say.
Don't want to assume, so we have no idea.
About Pee Wee Herman. Pee Wee Herman ended up going into a porn movie theater.
Yeah, Pee Wee jerked off in the movie theater.
And then whacking off what he was seeing on
you
the screen.
You did was just like that, TJ.
Well, I mean, he went to a porn theater. I mean, I never understood. I never understood why Pee Wee lost his job. Even as a kid, I'm like, so what? It wasn't like he did it on the show.
Or like on the street corner or something.
Yeah, I mean, like he went to the appropriate place to jerk off in those days, which was a porn theater, and he jerked off.
Yeah, it wasn't a daycare center or something
that. Who the fuck was harmed by that besides him?
It's just prudish America got to punish Pee-wee just because, you know, whatever, some shit in his personal life. It's stupid. So I defend Pee-wee. Fuck you, Brett Keen, you fat fucking turd.
Publicly, he was caught, he was arrested, and he never got to be that childhood superhero again. He never got to be.
Yeah, another thing is I'm not a children's
Pee-wee
entertainer
Herman anymore because Pee-wee Herman was a entertainer.
Yeah, but Pee-wee Herman hosted a kids show. All right, if he'd got caught jerking off in a porn theater, and you know, he was. Kind of, you know, he was like known as like an outsider making like some avant-garde movies or some shit. No one would have been like, oh my God, you know, don't let him make any more avant-garde movies. It doesn't matter. You know, I don't have the kind of fucking audience that is going to give a shit, apparently. Very apparently. So, you know, what's the fucking point?
Yeah, you're wasting your breath with this one, because no one cares. Anyone that cared has already stopped watching.
Yeah, like, people who don't like that, they're already gone.
That it happened so long ago that's, you know, and everyone already knows about it. You talk about it like it's some sort of big secret. Like, you didn't know this, huh?
Bringing their attention to
it. We have a fucking shirt with a banana, a hoodie with a banana on the back of it.
But there's no down arrow pointing to the ass.
Supposedly a comedian that was supposed to be there for kids. But it turns out that he liked to whack off to porn in a public movie theater.
Who cares?
A public movie theater. No, it wasn't a public movie theater. It was a porn theater.
It was a porn theater where they show porn.
He wasn't fucking watching.
What do you think men do in there?
Yeah, he wasn't there to watch like a real fucking film and then just whipped his dick out. Was like, you know, time to jerk it.
Yeah, he didn't show up to the fucking, you know, a special presentation of Casablanca or some shit. Like, yeah,
he did show up to the fucking Lion King. Like, damn, Simba looking fine tonight.
No. I mean, he fucking went to a porn theater to watch some porn. He watched some porn and he jerked off to it like men did when they went to porn theaters back when there were fucking porn theaters. You know, I'm sure that if Pee-wee had lived in the age of the internet, he would have jerked off in the safety and comfort of his own domicile and been fine.
Yeah. You know what? The internet could have prevented that.
You know, Pee-wee'd still be on the fucking air.
Finally,
The Rock has come back to the Drunken Peasants podcast.
Finally.
Spares. It's kind of odd because there's some movie theaters out there. There's actually places in some of these cities.
What a total aggression.
Sodom and Gomorrah.
Sodom and Gomorrah.
Where it's perfectly legal and okay for you to go in and do that. But apparently out of all the movie theaters Pee Wee Herman could have went, he went to the one where it's illegal to jerk off to the movie screen.
Oh my God! This Mel guy Gibson, is so dumb.
The movie screen. He took his wiener out and he looked at the movie screen and then he rubbed it and then he went to jail.
This is garbage.
It's just like he reiterates shit that's already happened a million times and a million, just in a million different fucking ways with like a slight twist, like, and this other guy did it, TJ, so you're basically a pedophile, TJ.
I don't know what the fuck Pee-wee Herman even has to do with this. He's like, he's not even talking about me anymore. He's been talking about Pee-wee Herman for the last 2 minutes.
Oh, he gets back to you.
I'm sure he does.
The video is Merry Christmas, Amazing Atheist, Drunken Peasants fans.
Yeah, you know, you would figure as a
Merry Christmas, Brad.
Yeah. Hold on, you would figure as a
water-headed fucking idiot,
fucking Christian, supposedly, if he was going to make a Merry Christmas video, it would be like a legitimate, nice, like Merry. Even though we disagree, guys, Merry Christmas from me to you, because this is the time to set all that stuff aside and, you know, goodwill towards man and Jesus' name and all this shit. But instead, it's like, you're fucking garbage, TJ.
Yeah.
Amazing atheist. You stuck a banana in your asshole. And Paul's ego is a sheep. He's a sheep.
He's a sheeple.
This video sucks. What's next?
Bye-bye, Brett.
Let's see. This one just says, taking on atheists.
All right.
Oh, God.
Wild Bill.
Out of the frying pan, into the fire.
Hello, everybody. Wild Bill for America here. And part of my mission in life is taking on the militant atheists.
Cool. Yeah.
I'm enjoying my coffee today and reading some of the 1,191 comments I got on my last atheist video. Now, who are the militants? They're the ones who say, there is no God, and we hate him.
Uh-huh. There is no God, and we hate him.
The God that they...
Define the militants, buddy.
That's not what the militants are. The militants, they want to convert other people. That's it.
Okay.
They say it does not exist. They use harassment and intimidation to try to herd people away from God. They use lawsuits and threats to block the message of Jesus Christ from being heard by school children or basically anyone in public culture. Now, atheists will use violence when they think they can get away with it. The world has seen that with the communist gulags, the mass graves, and the ovens in the concentration camps. Fortunately, here in the USA, we're still in the lies, threats, and harassment stage.
Yeah, but soon us atheists are going to get more power, and then it's to the fucking ovens with you, bitch.
It's the Third Reich all over again,
oh,
DJ.
Oh, it's the Fourth Reich, man. Yeah,
it's really going to be the Fourth
Empire. Motherfucking Fourth Reich up in this
the
bitch.
The Atheist Empire.
You believe in God? Die.
Seemed like, what was that, the Columbine, where atheists are just going to walk through buildings with guns.
So, JF, obviously Wild Bill's on to the whole atheist agenda. So, when we kill Wild Bill, do you want to fry him in an oven, or do you want to, gas him, or do you want to hang him, or do you want a firing squad? Mm. There's so many different ways we could kill him. It's fun to sit here and think about which method we can use after the takeover, you know, which is imminent. Oh, man.
I mean, this has been done so many times, people. It's the classical Hitler was an atheist. First, it doesn't make sense factually, and then it doesn't even make sense if it was the case. So it's hard to come up with any reply to this other than that it's the same stupid things we've been hearing for years.
Yeah, I mean, none of those people, even like Hitler was not an atheist, or, you know, he probably wasn't. There's no good evidence to say he was. There's plenty more evidence to say that he was a Christian. But even if you talk about Mao or Stalin or something, you know, those guys were atheists, sure, but they didn't kill people in the name of atheism. They killed people in the name of fucking communism. That's totally, communism and atheism are not the same thing.
Yeah, they were brutal dictators. I mean, what do you expect? I mean, they want power. They have achieved power, and they were going to do anything they have to do to keep it.
And then you get into, well, okay, if we do a death count, let's do the death count of Christianity, or let's do the death count of any religion. What would that mean? It would mean nothing. It would mean nothing even for current Christians or current Muslims. It's just non sequiturs all the way, and there's no reason why we would start counting how much people were killed in the name of some religion.
Yeah, because it's not like, unless it's 100% or something, or 99%, or like so pervasive that, yeah, obviously there's something wrong with these people because, you know, they're committing these acts at, you know, such tremendous rates that you have to believe that it's direct influence. But there's no.
I think it's an important subject because I've seen atheism is unstoppable. Do the exact same thing for Muslim. So basically, he's suggesting Muslim intrinsically makes you more violent. Muslim religion, Islam.
I don't think Islam intrinsically makes people more violent, but it does seem like even people who are not raised in Islamic cultures, they're very easily radicalized. And I think if you look at the text that they have as the basis for their religion, it's pretty easy to see why it's easy to justify radicalism using that text. I think it's a little harder to use the Bible because there's so much stuff that, you know, there is violent stuff in the Bible, of course, but there's so much other stuff that kind of is so antithetical to violence. I don't really feel like the Quran has the same admonishment towards violence that, the New Testament has.
I think that's an interesting point, and I'd be interested in seeing the statistics. But the reality is there's so many more Muslim than there are some other minor religion that even if there were more terrorists that are Muslim, I'm not sure we could make the case that necessarily it's Islam that makes you more violent.
I don't think you can say it's Islam alone. I think the causal link should definitely be investigated because it does seem like there's something there to me. But I don't jive with the idea of, I mean, obviously there's tons and tons of Muslims who are peaceful. There's tons who maybe they're not peaceful and maybe they have some regressive ideas, but they're not out there killing people. So there's, you know, it's a grab bag like any other group of people, of course. Man, look at this fuck.
And that's one reason why I oppose these people publicly, to try to keep militant atheists from degenerating into violence the way Islam does. The defense of faith and freedom begins with two things.
He's prayer, like the boy with his
bold,
finger in the dike.
Public
He's stopping all the atheists from fucking
so
going violent.
Vile, I can't repeat them. Those guys, I simply block with two clicks of the mouse, and then a third click deletes their filthy diatribe so that few, if any, get to read it.
Yeah, censor those fucks.
Did you hear that, guys? If you want your post to be read by people, keep it clean. Now, when they do try to make
hear
a case,
that, guys, go post some dirty shit
tired
on
lies,
Wild Bill's
that
page.
Science has proven the Bible.
That's what I heard.
Yeah.
Bible wrong. And man, it enrages them when I bring up the thousands of PhD level scientists who believe the Bible. Every church should have a subscription to Acts and Facts. Man, these things are just cool. Now, homosexuality is the bread and butter of the atheist today. Oh, don't worry about all the suicides, murders, and terminal illnesses. Or they declare that God is some kind of evil monster, and then they will wrench some obscure scripture out of context to try to prove their point.
Wow. Obscure scripture out of context. No.
And he says that homosexuality is the bread and butter of atheism. I'm not sure there's even a link between atheism and homosexuality, other than homosexuals are probably feeling repressed by religion.
Yeah, I would say that's probably the one commonality. I've known atheists who are homophobic. I've known Christians who are gay, gays who were Christian. I don't think there's a big causal relationship between atheism and homosexuality. But, you know, I mean, it's like, why even say that to him? Why even specify that? It's just, we know it's bullshit. Every word he says, I could see JF, like, smiling at, like, oh, my God. Oh, my God. He's laying on so thick. He's laying on even thicker. Holy shit. Just misstatement after misstatement.
Isn't that the proper reaction to one of his videos?
It is. Because it's just like, he lives in an alternate fucking universe. He's never even, he doesn't even understand what an atheist is. He's totally devoid of reality. He's just, you know, this disjointed, rambling bullshit. It doesn't have anything to do with anything that's actually happening anywhere. It's just like this total delusional, Wild Bill headspace.
All right, moving on. Here's a clip from CNN. Top advisor never known Trump to say something inaccurate.
True.
Executive Vice President of the Trump Organization, Michael Cohen, sir. Thanks for being
here.
How
are you?
Good to see you. Yeah.
Happy Thanksgiving.
So just clear this up. It's not the hugest deal in the world, but the campaign did initially describe the meeting with the African-American pastors as an endorsement.
You certainly are right about that. It's not the hugest deal in the world. I think there are much bigger issues
absolutely
going on
but
in
just
the world.
What happened? But, why the confusion? Yeah. Why the confusion?
Well, there was as Pastor Darrell Scott, who was one of the organizers, said today, there was a misstatement. There was a confusion between his group and the Trump campaign in putting out the endorsement. What ended up happening was exactly what we were hoping was going to happen. Many people endorsed Mr. Trump. Others left the meeting with a great feeling of love and a great feeling of mutual respect between the parties. And they are now going back to their respective churches.
So Trump just went in there and sucked their dicks, basically. He just paid a bunch of lip service to religion, I'm sure.
This was some black church thing.
Yeah.
He went and he met with a bunch of black church leaders and, you know, probably went in there and, yeah, like you said, suck their dicks. You're like, oh, I understand your concerns and, you know, all that horse shit. And then, you know, some of them endorsed him, most of them didn't. But, yeah, pretty much that.
Prey upon their decision.
All right, fair enough. I want to ask you about this claim, Mr. Trump saying he saw thousands and thousands of Muslims in New Jersey cheering as the Twin Towers came down on 9/11. Now, media organizations left, right, and center have searched for any footage of this. No one has produced even a still photo. The former New Jersey Attorney General, John Farmer, who was on the 9/11 commission, says his office heard the same rumor at the time. They investigated it. They found nothing. Farmer says, quote,
how come I'm under the impression that the FBI had detained quite a large number of people? And even over this weekend at a function that I was attending, I had a significant number of people turn around and say it wasn't just taking place in Jersey City. It also took place on Atlantic Avenue in Brooklyn.
I just want to ask you, detaining people and terrorist suspects or whatever happened with the FBI.
So the way of refuting the lie is just to double down and be like, actually, it wasn't even just in New Jersey. There was people in Brooklyn, too. It was everywhere. Pandemonium.
It's the Trump campaign.
Every street in America had a celebrating Muslim doing a little jig.
What did they do?
The towers done fell.
Did they just, like, assign Muslims, okay, you're going to be on this street corner, and, you know, at this time, just be ready to cheer?
Yeah,
you know, I mean, I think most Muslims in America probably, even if they like were happy that occurred, I think they're smart enough to go, I shouldn't go run into the street and cheer.
You know, but these Muslims in their Muslim neighborhoods, they feel safe, feel like they can just do it and no one will notice.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
But Trump was watching with his
eagle
eyes.
How the fuck
does
Trump know? Was he fucking there? Was he just like, let me go to New Jersey. Let's see if any Muslims are celebrating 9/11. And it's like, yay, 9/11. He's like, I got him.
He just wanted to go driving around to see if anyone was celebrating.
Know, all that happened was Trump heard the initial rumors that, you know, were already investigated, already shown to be false. you know, some misreported bullshit. He remembered it years later. He mentioned it. And then when it was shown to be false, he's just continued to run with it and say, well, you know, liberal media doesn't like me. They just refuse to listen to any evidence, but people have looked for the evidence. It's not fucking there. The closest you'll find is, like, you'll find a story about some guys with terrorist ties who were sitting on their rooftop with a model of the towers and shit, who obviously were aware of the attack before it happened. So these are guys who are obviously connected to terrorism, and they were celebrating, and the police got called on them and arrested them. That was the closest thing I could find that corroborated Trump's story, was eight guys who were terrorists celebrating when it happened. He said thousands of just Joe Blow Muslims are fucking cheering in the streets. That obviously did not happen. His insistence that maybe it did somehow, and we just haven't noticed it, or no one's been able to find any concrete proof of it. I mean, that's just preposterous. It's bullshit. I can't believe that they're not backing away from this lie. I mean, I guess I can, because people will let them get away with it. And, you know, there's probably plenty of Americans who still believe this is fucking true, even though there's no proof. There's no evidence, not a shred.
People don't, people don't normally get detained because they're sitting and having an ice cream, at their local ice cream shop. They were clearly doing something which gave enough cause to the FBI within which to detain people.
It's a separate issue, sir, but the basic question is this. How do you explain that there's no evidence?
Well, how many people were detained? I mean, you're citing this like, oh, well, way more people were detained. Well, show us a statistic. I mean, do you have anything? How many, were there thousands of Muslims detained on that day for celebrations? Is that what you're saying? Are you saying you have that? Because I don't think you do.
No video evidence for what Mr. Trump claims he saw on television. How do you explain that?
I'm not so sure that that's true, and I've worked for Mr. Trump now for a long time.
You're not sure that's true? What do you mean? Of course, people have gone over this shit with a fine-tooth comb. Trump said he saw on TV Muslims, yeah, woo, celebrating and shit. You mean to tell me that that happened, but no one can find it? No one on earth, not a one lone crazy Trump supporter or anybody? That video just doesn't exist. It's the first fucking video in the internet age that just vanished.
Liberal media, dude. They deleted it.
Wow. Obama must have fucking pulled some strings. That's all I can say.
And I do. You're in an interview, so you cannot be not so sure. It's your job to know. There's either a photo or there's not.
I can tell you that Mr. Trump's memory is fantastic, and I've never come across a situation where Mr. Trump has said something that's not accurate.
There are...
Wow, yeah. He's like a god.
Really? Like, Donald Trump has never been wrong. As long as you've known fucking Donald Trump, he's never once been like...
He has a phenomenal memory. He remembers everything. He's like an elephant. He never forgets. I know all things. Ask me any question. I know the answer.
How many Oreos have been created since they started making Oreos?
2.6 trillion.
Oh my God, you're a genius.
Yeah, I know these things. It's huge.
It's huge.
Seriously?
Yes, seriously.
Seriously.
All right, well, there is no video of this, is all I'm saying. There's no video of this, and you would think that by now somebody would have come forward and said, I mean, you have a lot of supporters out there. You're the Republican front runner.
You have a lot of people on Mr. Trump's social media saying, I saw it. I saw it with my own eyes. But
yeah, well, that's so meaningless. Anybody can say that. Plenty of people said they've seen angels and shit with their own eyes. Who gives a shit?
That's just proof of angels.
Yeah, I guess
yeah,
it is.
Yeah, where's the evidence? There's none. This is all bullshit, and they know it.
Then again, look, here's the problem. The problem is that the accusers, meaning the mainstream media, no matter what...
Accusers? Trump's the accuser. He's fucking accusing thousands of Muslim Americans of celebrating 9/11 without fucking evidence. He's the fucking accuser. Fuck you.
Donald Trump says they're going to try to refute to the best of their ability, and it's just not working. That's really the problem.
You don't think
it's
that
just not working.
You don't think that there are conservative media outlets out there who want Donald Trump to win, who want Donald Trump to be the next president, who would desperately love to put this up on their video, this video on their websites or on TV?
And they put up other things which corroborate Mr. Trump's statement.
No, but at the end of the day, you're talking about there are Christians that are getting their heads chopped off. There was a
In other countries around the world, not in fucking America.
Photo of a Christian woman who was killed by having a cross basically rammed through her head. We have our
Sounds awesome. It sounds like a scene from a horror movie.
President off somewhere talking about climate change. We have a very serious
climate change. Yeah, it's a very serious issue.
No.
It's a much more serious issue.
Not
than
according
one
to this fucking
cross shoved through their
goddamn
head.
Water-headed fucking idiot.
This guy should be Brett Keane's PR.
Yeah, he'd be perfect.
Serious issue in the United States, according to the FBI, that there are Islamic terrorist groups, ISIS-linked groups in every single state in this country. And we want to talk about whether or not that there were 1,000 people or 2,000 people that were sitting there and cheering, right?
Or
you have thousands of people on Mr. Trump's social media that attest to it.
All right.
Are you calling all of them liars?
Yeah. Why the fuck not?
Yeah, who the fuck are they?
What kind of argument is that? Are you calling these people liars?
How do we know it's not all the same person?
How do we know that they're not just making shit up to defend Trump? How do we know they're not misremembering the same bullshit he is? Like I said, there was rumors about this at the time. Of course, people can be sitting there, yeah, I think I saw that. I remember seeing that.
He's basically saying we don't need evidence because so many people agree with Trump. That's ridiculous. That's not evidence.
I could probably produce you thousands of people who said they were fucking abducted by aliens, too. You want to talk to them and take them seriously? Ben's tired, y'all. Ben needs his nappy. It's nap time for Ben.
I don't know who you're talking about. You're talking about people on Twitter. But let me move on, because obviously I have gotten as far as I can with this line of questioning. I do want to ask.
And at the end of the day, this line of questioning is really silly. And I mean, Sarah Murray, with even her previous statements, Sarah Murray is exactly one of those accusers that no matter what Donald Trump says, you guys are going to go ahead and take a look at and try to figure out a way how to diminish and demean
Mr. Trump.
It's the
scrutiny that comes with being a front runner when somebody's...
I don't see any other scrutiny being thrown at anybody to the extent that you're throwing...
Because he's the front runner, moron. What are you talking about? They just said it's the scrutiny of being the front runner. He's like, I don't see you scrutinizing the other... Yeah, because they're not the front runner. Trump's been the front runner this entire time. Of course he gets the most fucking scrutiny. Jesus.
It against Donald Trump. Let's move on.
But I do want to ask you, because I have not asked you yet, in defending his remarks about 9/11 and Muslims in New Jersey, Trump cited this report from 2001 in the Washington Post from Serge Kovaleski. Kovaleski is a reporter. He suffers from a condition that limits movement in his arms. Now, this is Trump at a rally talking about this reporter.
About Northern New Jersey. Draws the prober's eye, written by a nice reporter. Now the poor guy, you got to see this guy. Oh, I don't know what I said. I don't remember. He's going like, I don't remember. Maybe that's what I said.
All right. Now let's put up, there's a still photo of Donald Trump from that event and a picture of Mr. Kovaleski.
Okay,
Mr. Trump
so
insists
obvious, that's what
he was not making fun of Kovaleski's disability.
Yes, he
and
was.
He doesn't
Come
remember.
On. Come on. He was.
Yeah. Can we take this down so they can see this for a second? This fucking picture. This guy, yeah, Trump was not mocking this guy, all right? He was not. He was just acting flustered is what was happening. What if he's got the same, gimpy hand?
I'm not making fun of gimpy hand by doing gimpy hand. It's like,
gimpy hand, McGimpy hand. Jesus.
I've even meeting
my mind on Trump.
Yeah, what's that?
I stopped supporting Trump.
Huh?
You don't like him anymore?
But not based on this video. It was
what
just
it?
Recently this when he attacked the internet. Initially, I thought it would be hilarious to have Trump president of the U.S., but it was mostly for hilarity. But last week or 2 weeks ago, he said something about the internet, and it seemed like he was willing to limit the internet. And
he said he wanted to shut it down. He said, I'm going to shut the internet down.
Don't fuck with the internet. Even as a joke, I withdraw my support from Trump.
Can't even jokingly support him anymore.
So who are you supporting now?
Hitler.
Oh, I don't care because I'm not a Republican.
Kovaleski, who covered him in the past, But at that event...
Do you know, Jake, how many people do you think have covered Donald Trump in the past? Thousands upon thousands.
How many people with that disability? I would guess one.
Do you really think that Mr. Trump remembers this specific reporter? The answer is, Mr. Trump himself said he does not remember.
You said he has a fantastic memory.
He most certainly does. He sees thousands and thousands of reporters.
Wait a minute. You just said he never forgets anything.
He's got a fantastic memory.
Oh, my God. This guy.
Trump can't remember everybody he meets.
I think this guy's only talent is, like, Trump just needs someone who can go out there and just be a stone-faced liar for him. Like, just flat-out deny obvious truths.
Then he is doing a fucking marvelous job.
And just look like droopy-eyed and uninterested the entire time you're doing it.
A year. But he does not remember this guy. Now, let me say one more
thing.
Michael,
he said this was written by a nice reporter. He said it was written by a nice reporter. You got to see this guy.
He was talking about the article until he ended up pulling it back, which he did for whatever the reason that he did. But let me say this.
You got to see this guy, and then he mimics his injury.
Mr. Trump donates millions and millions of dollars each and every year in order to combat disabilities, in order to combat kids.
Don't like John Cena? Well, he helps Make-A-Wish kids.
Yeah, Make-A-Wish kids. Come on.
Still don't like John Cena?
Donald Trump gives millions and millions of dollars to disabled people, so it's okay. I mean, whatever. You know, if Donald Trump wants to make fun of this handicapped dude, it's fine. But don't deny that's what it was afterwards. I mean, come on. It's so clear it's what it was. You know, just say that's what it was and it was wrong. That's the thing. Trump never admits he's wrong. It's just like, no, you just don't understand what I was doing. You don't understand what I was really saying. I mean, come on. Just fucking admit when you're wrong, for fuck's sake. I guess that would just kill him with his voters, though. Trump back down from something. He can't be president now. He's a pussy. He admits when he's wrong.
Answer, whether it's children, where he donates millions of dollars a year. Mr. Trump is not the type of individual that's going to make fun of somebody's disability. He wouldn't know this guy prior to this entire
nonsense.
But
we just saw him do it.
He was making fun of his disability. He was not making fun. He was being gesticulate, which Donald Trump is, and he was basically showing the exasperation of a reporter that's pulling back on a story, exasperation, and basically saying something like, oh, now I don't remember, now I don't remember. Had nothing to do with
his
disability.
And it just so happened, but first of all, he said, he's a nice guy, and then he said, you got to see this guy, and then he twists his arms to mimic the
disability. He wasn't twisting his arm to mimic anything. And, you know, going back to the guy from the Black Lives Matter, the guy was so far away from the group, Mr. Trump had no idea if it was a male, if it was female, though, from the voice. He probably could tell, but he was so far away with lights in his eyes. He had no idea.
Lights in his eyes. The light was in his eyes. He didn't even see this guy.
This guy is like just the king of fucking excuses. Like, Donald was a little sick that day. His eyes weren't working properly. There's bright lights. You know, like, he was under pressure. There's thousands of people. It's like, God damn, how fucking thick do you need to lay this on?
Very, apparently. There's no way Donald even saw this guy. There's a million pieces of evidence against it.
It's the same issue. It's the accusers will continue to accuse Mr. Trump and not give him a fair chance,
Michael,
within which, no matter what you tell me, Jake, I disagree with you.
Let me ask you a question.
Mr. Trump would never, ever make fun of somebody's disability.
Okay.
End of story.
Let me ask you this question.
No, bullshit, not end of story.
Do you ever have a conversation with him and say, you know, you really actually could be president. You're the front runner of the you could get the Republican nomination. You actually could win. Now's maybe a time to be a little bit more of a statesman and not attack people on Twitter and not make fun of whatever. Like, do you guys ever have that conversation?
Well, we definitely talk about Mr. Trump being the front runner, and we definitely talk about Mr. Trump winning the presidential
Seriously, Trump, yeah, that's great. Trump gets more and more popular all the time. Why would anyone have that conversation with him? Why would anyone sit Trump down? You know that crazy shit you keep doing that keeps getting more and more people to support you? Stop that. That would be the dumbest fucking political consultant ever. Of course that guy ain't doing that shit. Why would he? Trump, the media doesn't like you. We know you're probably going to get the Republican Party's nomination, but you better change your strategy nonetheless. you know, your whole being the front runner easily for months upon months thing just isn't working out anymore. I mean, give me a fucking break.
In this upcoming election, and I will tell you that at this this meeting that we had today with the pastors, I will tell you that the topic did come up, that many of the pastors said that we are taking a tremendous amount of heat as a result of some of these comments, despite the fact that they are inaccurate, that the media loves to portray Mr. Trump in a negative light.
I'm just airing video of him, Michael. I mean, that's not, I'm not portraying him in a negative light. We just aired video. And
you also aired video of Mr. Trump when he turned around. He said that Mexico was sending in, you know, all different types of people. And what he never said that they're Hispanic. He never said that they're Mexican. The whole world knows that there's 2,000 miles of.
He did say it.
He did all this shit. It's like this dude just rewriting history. Donald Trump never did anything bad.
Those people coming from Mexico, he never claimed they were Mexican.
I mean, we know that more than just Mexicans come across the Mexican border, but
mostly
it's like,
Mexican.
Well, we know what he was talking about. He's like, basically, there's a certain kind of people that I don't want in this country, and it just so happens that they're basically all like just take it from Mexico down like south. That's it. So we know what he's saying.
Oh my God. This guy is a fucking riot, man.
Yeah.
Dude, this guy, like, if you ever need a lawyer or something, this is your guy.
Open border that people are sifting through. He was bringing that up. He's not scripted. This is something that we understand.
Sure.
Mr. Trump is not your prototypical politician. He's not a politician.
Agreed.
He is an entrepreneur extraordinaire. He's insanely bright.
Bright. Does Trump, like, require that everyone who talks about him speaks in the same hyperbolic terms that he himself uses? Like, if you're going to describe me, you have to say I'm extraordinary.
I'm insanely bright.
Yeah, I'm just like monumentally charismatic, awesome beyond all reason.
An entrepreneur extraordinaire.
A flawless example of human decency to the core. Now kill them children.
Doer, and what he will do is his mantra, he will make America great again. And this is the takeaway that these pastors who came
to see. Well, let me ask you this, Michael, what's your message to the disabled little boy or little girl who see that video and say,
suck a dick. Suck a dick.
Look at that. You look at this child. Think of
the
children.
What do you say to the poor disabled little boy or girl? Fuck you. Ugh. You're making me fucking want to side with the Trump supporter with that fucking saccharine vomit-inducing bullshit.
What? Sure,
he
looks
for
as
Trump.
Though the Republican.
No, this guy does. I'm talking about this other guy.
Oh yeah, okay.
The front runner is making fun of a physical disability, and even though he says he's not, it sure looks as though he is. And what's the message to that little boy and little girl?
The message is that Donald Trump.
Look at him.
I mean, come on.
Ugh.
It's so obvious.
Would never, not today, not yesterday, not ever, would never make fun of another person's disability.
Seriously.
Ever. End of story.
Let me ask you a question.
I love this statement there because I think we should go in the past of Donald Trump and scan everything that he's ever said. I'm pretty sure we'll find something.
Well, we know he wants to bang his own daughter.
Oh, yeah.
We know that for sure.
That's so fucking obvious.
He said it so many different times.
If she wasn't my daughter, I'd hit it.
Yep, basically.
Even if I was just drunk.
Donald Trump continues to lead both in the national polls and almost all of the early state polls. You could argue with Iowa. But there are a lot of insiders in the Republican Party who attribute that to the Republican base being angry. That's what they say. Their words, not mine.
Rightfully so.
32% of Republicans describing themselves as angry. Only 12% of Democrats describe themselves as angry. If Mr. Trump wins the Republican presidential nomination.
You know, it's weird because 32% of the Republican voters describe themselves as angry, and that's about where Trump sits in the polls, too, at about 30-something percent.
Huh.
So that is kind of interesting. Interesting little parallel. I wonder how many of those are angry. I wish they asked how many of those angry people who they were supporting, because I bet you it would be strongly.
How many?
Well, what are they angry about? You know, it's like we're angry, but it's such a vague thing. Like we're upset. It's like, what are you upset?
They're angry
about?
From this for the same stupid shit that Wild Bill is angry about. You know, just nonsense shit that ain't even happening.
How many Republicans will defect and vote for Hillary
if Trump gets the nomination.
No, probably not. Probably not.
Not
a huge
many.
Amount.
Not I mean, much. They hate Hillary.
I mean,
so
they hate her so much. If it was, I mean, if it's Bernie, maybe a few more, but it's probably gonna be Hillary. So I don't see too many people defecting.
How will voters who may not be feeling angry? How will he appeal to them? How will they respond to his message?
And who are we referring to at this with this question?
Well, like independent voters, the persuadables, the voters in the middle, not the necessarily like Republicans who might switch tickets, Democrats who might switch tickets, independent voters.
Donald Trump is going to transcend the Republican Party. He beats Hillary in a head-to-head today, and he will if, in fact, it becomes a Trump versus Clinton election. Donald Trump is a uniter.
So
what he plans on doing is he plans on reaching out to all of the minority communities and basically... Donald Trump provides inspiration, hope. They know him to be a doer. This country is in terrible shape, both as a country, domestic as well as internationally.
This country is not really in terrible shape. I've been around. I've seen some countries. Seem like we're doing all right. I mean, you know, there's definitely countries doing way worse than we are by far. Not saying that we're okay on every fucking front. Like JF said, the military interventionism and shit, constantly sticking our nose where it doesn't belong, trying to have the American empire, you know, on the down low. Yeah, that shit's got to stop. There's some fucked up laws on the books. The war on drugs is a failure. Prison overpopulation. Plenty of fucking problems, really, but it could be so much worse. So many places that, you know, I would not want to be.
Should we screen cap this?
You know, anytime that someone has their mouth open like that, pretty much the answer is yes. I expect him to shoot an egg at me like Birdo or something.
Birdo. God, I loved that level.
Oh, the fucking Birdo. That was a rip. That, they used that boss a few times.
Yeah, they did.
Boom, ba-doom.
Horrible things going on across this globe. We have refugee situation that's, you know,
individual.
That's really out of control. And what Donald Trump is going to do is he's going to put things like he does in his own business.
Wait. So the same guy that's like, climate change, bullshit. And it's like, now we got all these refugee situations. Like, I wonder why... I wonder why that... What was the catalyst? Was it drought and all these other problems? And no, that wasn't it. That wasn't caused by global warming. No. The impact we see on the environment from climate change is, you know, just all these crazy weather events, you know, and patterns occurring. You know, hey, it's no big deal. We'll all be fine.
The fact that I was wearing a T-shirt outside in late December in Ohio is...
In winter.
Yeah.
You know...
I've been through some Ohio winters. I've never had one where I could just walk around in a t-shirt for so many days. It's pretty strange. I know winter just officially got underway, but, you know, in Ohio, winter really is most of the fall, too. Or usually it is.
Yeah.
Not
like,
this year.
Even like the end of October, it'll start snowing.
Yeah, we haven't had any snow. We had some that, you know, we had a few times, but it didn't accumulate.
Right.
I mean, I know there's this El Nino shit going on and all these weird... weather events, but yeah, it's pretty strange. Droughts in California, unseasonal warmness in some places, unseasonal coldness in others. But no one be concerned. I'm sure it's fine.
This back on track, and he's going to make this country great, very much like he did his own company.
All right, Michael Cohen, we thank you. As always, you and Mr. Trump, you take the questions, you answer them. Appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Good to see you, Jake.
Good to see you.
I mean, I guess he answered them in the loosest possible sense of the word. Thank you for coming on my show and lying boldly to my face several times.
We have some more wonderful Trump footage also.
Oh, great.
Let's see. Trump tackles Clinton video claim.
Never mind their primary fights. Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton are locked in a new brawl of their own tonight. He's demanding an apology for this.
And we also need to make sure that the really discriminatory messages that Trump is sending around the world don't fall on receptive ears. He is becoming ISIS's best recruiter.
At the weekend,
Oh, God damn it. You fucking moron. You have this perfect fucking storm of stupidity in Donald Trump. He said a million and one stupid fucking things. But then you got to go say something about him that's just patently stupid and untrue. Like, there's so many legitimate attacks you could make, and you literally go for some nonsense like, ISIS loves Trump!
That's some, like, fumbled attempt at fucking tying Donald Trump to, like, the most hated group in the world right now. That's all that is. Donald Trump and ISIS in the same sentence.
They're the same. They love him. He's the biggest recruitment tool. ISIS sees that shit, and they're like, yeah!
Democratic debate, Clinton said Trump's plan to block Muslims from entering the U.S. has emboldened ISIS fighters.
They are going to people showing videos of Donald Trump insulting Islam and Muslims in order to recruit more radical jihadists.
So what is your suggestion? To censor Trump? Is that your suggestion? Because what else do you want? I mean, if you believe in freedom of speech, like, I believe in freedom, Hillary, then, you know, you could say you disagree with him, but, you know, he still has a right to say it, even if it is retarded.
Okay, you know, the problem isn't that Trump is saying this in a vacuum. The problem is Trump is saying this shit, and there's tons of Americans who agree with him. So isn't the problem that there's so many Americans that think that way? But, of course, he's not going to attack them because it's like, well, maybe they might vote for me at some point. It was just, oh, Trump, you know, ISIS has used him as a recruiting tool. They go around showing people Trump videos and shit. I mean, as far as those people are concerned, most of them are not speaking English. You can show them videos of Trump and fucking dub it over to say any damn thing. Put any subtitle on there. Doesn't even matter. So what does it even fucking mean? Nothing.
Explain why this is not in America's interest to react with this kind of fear and respond to this sort of bigotry.
But there's no evidence to back up her assertion Trump's rhetoric has been a recruiting tool for ISIS.
Of course not.
So far, ISIS recruiters have used American presidents, her husband, President Bush, and President Obama in recruiting videos. The accusation set Trump off. He fired back on Twitter. It's the Democrats' total weakness and incompetence that gave rise to ISIS, not a tape of Donald Trump that was an admitted Hillary lie.
You know, it's not even that either. What it is George W. Bush went to fucking Iraq against everybody.
Went to a volatile and already unstable fucking region of the world that we all know and recognize. You say the Middle East and people go, oh, okay.
Yeah, like pretty much anywhere in American history, if in a newspaper it says unrest in the Middle East, you know, that headline will fit. There's never a time when it's like, oh, that's surprising. That's not happening right now.
The two sides of the debates are totally wrong. And it's just hilarious to see people trying to attribute ISIS faults to people in America. Like, you're not going to find a cause of ISIS within the American behavior. Neither Donald Trump nor the interventions, maybe you could argue, but even that is a long shot.
I don't know if it's that much of a long shot, because, I mean, you know, these are regions that used to be pretty rigidly controlled by dictators. Now, you could say those dictators were horrible, and of course they were, but we went in there, we destabilized those regions, we kicked Saddam Hussein out of power, the Arab Spring followed, all these fucking dictators getting deposed, or at least losing some of their holdings, and of course these radical groups are rising up to fill the power vacuum. So I do think it can be laid at the feet of Americans, particularly those who supported the Bush administration.
I don't exclude this, but I find the explanation very focused on recent history. And the reality is that there's been terrorism and there's been Islamic terrorism for much longer than this scale
right.
of explanation.
Very true. But my point is that those elements were there, but people like Saddam Hussein and their sheer brutality were keeping a lid on that shit. Because it wasn't in their best interest for that to exist. But as soon as we came out there and fucking removed the fucking lid that Saddam was keeping crushed on the jar, we opened Pandora's box. We let all that shit out. That'd be my opinion. I agree it goes back much further. But there was a lid on it. Maybe that lid was destined to blow no matter what. I don't know. But we certainly didn't help shit by going in there and kicking ass and taking names and acting like we had some real reason to be there when everyone knows we really fucking didn't. Hey, kitty.
That's defensible.
I saw your cat.
Yeah, my cat.
I want to pet it. Let me pet your pussy, JF.
Hello.
Aw. Cat's like, I don't want this. I'm gone. All right. That's enough of this Trump shit. What else we got?
Let's see. We got Theodore Shubat
saying he would invade India and outlaw yoga.
Yeah.
All right, let's take a look.
And these Hindu bastards who are killing Christians. And what angers me even more about it is the fact that most people believe that Hinduism is a peaceful religion when it's not. If I had complete control, like if I was a dictator of an empire, I would invade India, I would destroy all the Hindu temples, destroy all their idols, and I would do what the Portuguese did. I would force people to convert to Christianity. I would say, listen, convert to Christianity.
I mean, there is violence in Hinduism, of course.
Yeah. There's extremists in every religion.
I would say it is mostly peaceful that I'm aware of.
Yeah, no, Ben. This guy, if he was a dictator of a country, this guy right here would invade those fuckers.
Yeah, so he wants to kill them and then force them to convert.
Wouldn't that mean Christianity is the violent religion and Hinduism is more peaceful?
No. The religion that goes and conquers people and kills them and converts them at, you know, under threat of violence, that's the religion. That's the peaceful religion.
Oh. Huh?
That's the very teenager thinking, if everyone thought like me, it would work. But that's precisely the kind of thinking that puts you in a conflict.
India is a nuclear power, by the way. I don't think they would be so easy for you to conquer.
You need to convert. I would destroy all of their temples. And I would have people preach to them, of course. And destroy that would be temples.
So you want to be the Christian version of ISIS. Okay.
You need to Christianize the...
Yeah, this guy.
Awesome.
This guy.
Good
really,
to know.
If you want to tie someone to ISIS, this guy.
Right? I want to destroy their temples. I want to fucking make them convert. It's like, okay, so you sound like basically the Christian version of ISIS. Like you really wish a bunch of other Christians would get together with you and make this a reality.
Land, and of course, I think God will intervene, just as God intervened in Mexico with the vision of the Our Lady of Guadalupe, and that ended up leading to the conversion of millions of Indians. And so I'm sure that God would intervene in that situation and many, many Hindus would convert through God's intercession. And I would make it very clear, we need to destroy these false religions. End of story. Hinduism is an evil, demonic, antichrist religion. It needs to be uprooted from the earth. And it has no place in the world. It really does. It does nothing good for anyone. It's useful to no one. Yoga, outlawed. And anyone who teaches yoga, punished by the state. Punished. You need to be punished. You need to be.
The economy of California is going to fucking shrink if you do this.
So wait, I mean, like, how many stretches? I mean, like, what if you're just doing is stretching?
What does this mean for the fate of yoga pants? Even more importantly,
that is a good point, Ben.
This man must be stopped.
I know.
Thankfully, no one's listening to him. But,
yeah.
Oh my God! What a fucking idiot. I mean, how many people actually listen to this fucking guy? Is there like a sizable number of people that are watching this?
I doubt
it.
He's always on Right Wing Watch all the time.
I think it's because he just comes right out and says this crazy shit.
Yeah.
With no restraint whatsoever. Like, yeah, I would kill people.
Oh, yeah.
I'd conquer
he
countries.
He gives no fucks.
I'd force people to become Christians.
I'll give him that. He does not give a shit.
Theodore Shubat.
What do you think of him, JF? You like him?
I mean, I don't like yoga, but I wouldn't like make it illegal to do yoga.
Why not?
Well, I think if these people want to stand on their head, it's fine. I have nothing for it or against it.
What about what about destroying the Hindu temples? You agree with that?
Obviously, look at him.
I mean, yes, let's just start a war of religion for no reason at all. Why not?
Yeah. We're all thinking that. Like, let's just start a religious war. Come on, guys.
We're tired of fighting Muslims. Let's fight some fucking Hindus. Come on.
We're fine. We're all Muslims now. Whatever. Let's just go kill all these Hindus now. We hate them.
We can even make peace with the Muslims. Look, Muslims, how about you and I, we fucking bury the hatchet. You know, Christianity and Islam, let's go kill these fucking Hindus.
Oh,
and when we're done, we'll go fuck those atheists up.
Oh, well, Pakistan would be on our side then, for sure.
Yeah, man. Pakistan can help. You tired of India's shit, Pakistan? The Christians and the Muslims are getting together, brah.
Gonna kick some ass.
Kick a shot of these fucking Hindus with their many gods. That's bullshit, yo.
Be treated like the U.S. treated the Cuban mafia with cocaine. I mean, The Cubans came in here, tried to sell mafia, tried to sell cocaine. The U.S. government eventually cracked down on it. And I think
and now you can't get cocaine anywhere.
Yep, totally gone.
It's gone. Eradicated. From America. You go to a drug dealer and ask for cocaine, they're like, coke what? I don't even
good one. Yeah, it's like, you know, come on, dude.
The U.S. government needs to crack down on this evil
Americans
thing
love drugs.
Treat it like it's a drug. Seriously, treat it like it's a drug. You're teaching yoga, have the SWAT team bust open the doors in that place and just arrest everybody. It needs to be destroyed.
I cannot believe someone just said that, seriously. Like, imagine a fucking yoga studio and like SEAL Team 6 comes down, rappels down from the helicopter, kicks in. It's like, get down, yoga people! Oh, fire! And they just like kill them all. It's like, oh god, they were doing yoga in there, sir. People are like fucking, they're scarred for life. They have post-traumatic, they have fucking nightmares of people doing yoga and shit. It's like, come on.
This position is called the Happy Otter.
So
what?
What do you want to do now?
What do you mean?
Let's do cocaine.
Are there more videos?
Yeah, I got a couple.
Is it time?
I got a couple.
Is it time to end? I mean, how long are we going?
Let's see. The timer at the bottom here will tell us. How long does that say?
2 minutes. 2 hours and 24 minutes.
All right, okay. One more video then, I guess.
One more video.
One more video.
Before we end the show. But we'll be back tomorrow, you guys.
Back again. Guess who's back?
So it won't be too back long of a wait.
Truck and peasants are back.
You know, I'm not a scientist or whatever. You know, I have read that.
I love when they start with this.
Reptiles.
The homosexual lobby.
But JF, don't you say that everyone should be a scientist anyway? So this guy's attempt to live your words. So you can't criticize.
I'm going to start this over so you can actually hear.
No, I'm not criticizing. I love when they say that. Like, I'm not a scientist, but.
You know, I'm not a scientist or a whatever, but.
He's not a whatever.
You know, I have read that reptiles continue to grow until they die.
Yeah. I've heard that too.
So like you think about.
Yeah.
There's not a single animal that doesn't grow.
Oh, bullshit. If that were true, 90 year olds would be 8'10".
No, you don't have to grow in height. You can grow, for example, if you get a cut, you can get a cicatrice, or I don't know what's the name in English, but
no,
a cut repairing.
No, that's wrong,
that's a
JF.
Form of growth. And
no, it's not.
The all the other events in your body, they all count as a development and growth.
I don't think so. That's wrong.
Earth. Mm-hmm. I mean, you got people living 969 years. No reason to doubt that.
69.
Yeah, so
there is plenty of reason to doubt that, because now in modernity, we don't see people living, you know, to 100 even commonly. Like, you know, it's becoming more common, but no one's making it to 969 years.
Yeah.
Gentlemen, do not doubt this book, Methuselah, 969 years he lived.
I completely doubt
the book. So longevity, obviously, for all living things, was much greater before the flood.
Yeah.
So you think about a lizard.
Longevity was much greater before the flood.
Guys. Based on no evidence at all.
Yeah.
He's not a scientist or whatever.
Based on the Bible.
I know damn well people used to live 969 years, brah. Before the flood, of course.
I mean, here's a lizard living for 200 years.
Yeah.
What if you had this same lizard
living for
1,000 years?
Right.
Continuing to grow. You imagine
dinosaurs,
the size,
dude,
that he would be.
Oh, I see where he's going with this. This is even more retarded than I thought. Yeah, here's the problem. A dinosaur is not just a giant lizard. Like, there was no dinosaur that looks like just a big gecko or something, or a giant iguana.
Don't they think dinosaurs actually had like feathers and shit now too? It's not just like
fuck that feather shit. No.
Maybe some of them.
Yeah, some of them.
None of them did. That's wrong. I don't like it.
TJ, Jurassic Park is just a movie.
I don't like it.
It's just a movie.
That's where dinosaurs came from.
Yeah, I'm thinking that could be the explanation for dinosaurs.
Dinor. Buy the dinor shirt.
Yeah, it's the explanation for dinor. Jesus is riding dinor
somewhere in America. Found the old solution to the existence of dinosaur. He found it in the Bible. They were just big lizards.
Yeah,
remember Dinor.
People used to live 969 years, so a lizard back then could have lived for 200 years.
No problem.
I mean, not 200, 2,000 years, man.
A million years, who knows, man.
Who knows how long? Well, the Earth isn't even that.
A million years, TJ. They could live a million.
The Earth is only 6,000
years
old.
You know what? They can live 6,000 years, then.
But that's why there were these giant lizards, man, but they went extinct. Because they got too big for their britches.
Tiles.
Couldn't fit on the ark.
Grew. Makes for sense. 1,000 years, kept growing.
Wow. So that was his bright idea that he had.
Pretty brilliant.
He solved the fucking mystery.
Everyone, please subscribe if you're not subscribed. Give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed the show.
Why wouldn't there be like little tiny like brontosaurus looking lizards and shit?
Yeah, I want to see those. So I'm totally cool with those.
Yeah. So sad. All right. Well, be sure to RSVP for our event if you're coming, and that's pretty much
it. A bunch of people got invited. I wonder if weird people are just, like, randomly inviting people.
Hopefully not.
I have no idea.
Those fucks.
Those fucking assholes.
And get a Dinor shirt, and then when the Dinor shirts reach their destination, take a picture of yourself wearing the Dinor shirt.
We may even sign your Dinor shirt if they go out. Oh, when's the campaign going to end? Because it takes about 5 days after it ends to get the shirts.
I don't know.
You guys are fucking useless.
If people have the shirts.
You're fucking useless, TJ.
If people have the shirts when they come to the event, they can get it signed. You can get anything signed.
You're fucking
event,
shut up, TJ. Yeah.
We'll sign shit.
No.
All right. Anyway, that's all for the show. Hope we'll see you guys tomorrow, really. And thanks to JF for being on and philosophizing with us about vegetarians.
Everyone, just do cocaine. That's my advice to you.
If you could find it, but you can't because the government put a stop to that shit.
Okay.
All right. Good night, everybody.